is, what's her name? Crap. Jody Westby. That's right. Her name is Jody Westby. And she's a female attorney and CEO of a company called Global Cyber Risk LLC. Listen to this story by John Vibes at thefreethoughtproject.com. Headline, please leave our neighborhood. Rich white woman defends elderly black man from cops. Last week, an elderly African-American man was walking through a wealthy neighborhood when outside of Washington, D.C., he was confronted by two African-American Washington Metro police. Without any reason, the officers stopped the man and began to question him. The man had allegedly expressed some dissatisfaction with how he had been singled out, and the officers then ordered him to get on the ground. Jody Westby, a white female attorney and CEO of a company called Global Cyber Risk LLC, witnessed the altercation while working from her home office. She immediately ran out to confront the police and asked her housekeeper to record the developing situation. Westby quickly ran to the man's defense, saying that he was a friend and associate of many people living in the area. The police informed Westby that they were responding to a report of burglary and said that they stopped to question the man to see if he had anything to do with the incident. Westby did not back down and demanded that the officers tell her the address of where the report came from. When they provided her with the address, she informed them that they were blocks away from the alleged crime and weren't even in the right neighborhood. Then she informed the officers that she is an attorney and that they did not have the right to detain him. After threatening to report the officers, she picked the man up and carried him away, saying to them, please leave our neighborhood. Westby then said to the officers as they were driving away, just because he's black doesn't mean he's here to rob a house. He works for us. He's been in this neighborhood for 30 years. Westby then said to the officers, oh, right. Westby later said, you got a white woman and a Hispanic woman standing up for a black man against two black cops. It was shameful how they behaved. And if it were Columbia Heights or some other neighborhood, it'd probably be worse. It was very interesting in the sense of getting a picture of how black cops treat other black people and how humiliating that was for him and how they were treating him just like a dog. This incident shows how important it is for people to stick up for one another and start recording and asking questions when someone is being hassled by a police officer. If there was just one person like Jody Westby on every street, the world would be a safer place. Here's the video.
We have a call. Excuse me, what address did you get a call for? What address did you get a call for?
46.
Pardon? What number, please?
State?
But you don't even know my sister. She's 50 something years.
Dennis, let me handle this.
I know.
Dennis. Dennis.
If by chance she verified you work here, I have no problem.
It's 4602 and you're in the 4500 block. 4500. That house isn't even in this neighborhood.
He's coming. We have a burglar. He's coming with facts.
No.
He gets loud and boisterous.
Because you're accusing him.
Didn't accuse anything.
I'm sorry, but you need to get your officer.
I'm telling you, because the most foolish officers know who I am. Most of them, you know.
Did not accuse him.
You do accuse him. You're accusing me.
No, where was he coming from? That's what everything else he got.
She has. She's refused.
I've done the public out here. I know every part of the public.
Or videotaping.
Refuse anything.
Come on, Dennis.
Sir.
He said you can go.
No, because.
Come on, you're coming. Come on.
And tell me, you know, my sister, Mr. Parker, Bowie. I'm disabled.
Come on. You just come with me.
I know it. No, stop.
No, this
isn't the address.
My God. He doesn't have the authority to stop him.
You know,
need to tell her that.
I'm
reporting this. Okay. I'm an attorney, and this is wrong.
That's
now,
wrong.
Please leave our neighborhood. Come on.
Would you like a card?
Hey.
Ma'am, would you like a card? Here you go.
Yes, I do want your card.
Sit down, then.
Yeah.
Let me go get that
card.
Okay.
Oh.
So then the videographer takes the card and they walk away. So that's the video. If we had a person like Jody Westby on every street, the world would be a better place. Because you know what? She's not afraid to stand up to arbitrary authority and use logic and reason to say, hey, where were you called to, officer? Oh, 4200 block? Well, you're on the 4500 block. So I guess you're in the wrong place then, aren't you? See ya. Beat it. You're a punk cop and you're here to hassle people and treat them like animals, telling a man to sit on the ground while you wear your blue gloves of authority and order him, like a dog, to stand on the ground. This woman, she has the audacity to say on video, I haven't refused him anything. Well, you're refusing him his freedom, aren't you? You're telling him he doesn't have the freedom to stand up and walk away, even while this white woman attorney stands up and grabs this man to help him up as he stands because he's disabled. She starts walking away with him. The cop again says, hey, wait, don't go anywhere. Oh, but don't stop her. Whitey got involved. Oh, and she says she's an attorney. So now I'm just going to bow down. I mean, this is a joke. The respect that people show arbitrary authority. First, it goes from the uniformed person to the white person because they're wearing a different color skin because they threatened that they're an attorney because it looks like they have money. I mean, the reasons that people bow down to authority and lick the boots, it's disgusting. I'm sorry. I usually don't freak out this much, but like this is a peaceful resistor that deserves major applause. I want more people to do this. You have a video camera. You're polite. You're assertive. And you stand up for people's rights. You don't let people get pushed around. It doesn't have to be you standing up for yourself. It could be you standing up for another person, as this woman is. She's standing up for a man who can't defend himself. He's sitting there surrounded by police. They're holding him to the ground, telling him he's not allowed to move. He could have been arrested. Could you imagine? Would that be a better thing for him? Some of the comments from this article read, props to the lady for standing up for these bullies. And then one person says, well, the woman cop was the bully. It looked like the cop in the car was just fine. And, you know, she wasn't taking any S from these two. Good for her. And as S as it may be, if she hadn't interfered, then there's no telling what could have happened to this man. And some people say, oh, nothing would have happened other than he'd been fined for vagrancy. The cops were in the wrong, but they don't usually mistreat people, as you seem to want to insinuate. It's the way the city makes money. Let's not blow it up before blow it up to more than it was. Just a dumb cop that saw an opportunity to arrest someone. So varied reactions, but I think that this person did something very courageous. She herself could have been arrested. Taking a person away who the cops are detaining for having committed a crime or being suspected of having committed a crime, I mean, that's a pretty serious charge. That's something that's obstructing an investigation, right? Obstructing government administration. There are a few charges that could be, you know, aiding and assisting in a crime. There are a few charges that could be associated with that. But she's not afraid to take on charges. She's assertive and she knows she's in the right. Finally, we turn to what's happening in Hong Kong, the umbrella revolution, as it's being termed. Well, some violence erupted over the weekend, and unfortunately, some reporters from the World Crypto Network were hit. James Kang, I believe, is his name. He's been reporting from Hong Kong at a website. I can't really read the name because it's in Chinese, but I think if you Google umbrella revolution, you should be able to see. Now, a news story develops as the Blue Ribbon, a new group who opposes democracy, is marching in the streets to demand an end to the protests. A protest to end protests. Yes, this is really happening. We'll have to report on it on Tuesday because we're out of time for Peace News. Catch us online at peacenewsnow.com and up next on LRN.FM, it's Free Talk Live.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be. I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here. And I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Instead of just listening, you can also watch. See the Liberty Radio Network's key New Hampshire-based live shows via our studio cam at cam.lrn.fm. Plus, you'll still be able to listen to the Liberty Radio Network via the cam feed in high quality 24/7, even when there's no live show being produced in our Keene studio. But wait, there's more. Our chat room is built into the cam page so you can interact with other listeners online. Listen, watch, and chat. All free at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Lock it here for more live content. Free Talk Live is next on the Liberty Radio Network. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, October 12th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.41 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,224 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $360. Antiwar.com reports losses continue to mount in the Kurdish town of Kobani along the border between Syria and Turkey, and while the YPG militia says they've succeeded in defending the town's central square, the Islamic State takeover continues to seem inevitable. Kurdish militia officials pushed for a further escalation of U.S. airstrikes against the Islamic State and the surrounding area, though with the fighting now taking place street to street inside the town itself, it's hard to imagine the U.S. being able to target the fighters without leveling neighborhoods. The Islamic State has been pushing against Kobani on and off for months now, and in the offensive over the last several weeks has seized more than 350 villages in the surrounding area. The loss of Kobani effectively means the end of a significant independent Kurdish presence in Aleppo. It could also be the beginning of the end for an independent Syrian Kurdistan as the remnants fall back into the northeastern corner of the nation and refugees continue to pour into Turkey. Though they're all ethnically Kurdish, the leadership in Iraqi and Syrian Kurdistan are starkly different, with the Iraqi Kurdish government built around a handful of powerful families and the Syrian Kurdish territory run mostly by political parties with their roots in Turkey. FPP Radio News is brought to you by The Doublespeak Dictionary. The Doublespeak Dictionary by Leslie Starr O'Hara satirizes the marked difference between the ideal of we the people and the reality of we the elite, while offering an insightful glimpse into the clockworks of the totalitarian mind. Ever irreverent, but never irrelevant, the Doublespeak Dictionary serves as a subversive and humorous, but timely reminder that the emperor has no clothes. The Doublespeak Dictionary is available from Amazon.com and all major bookstores. Wired reports lawyers for Ross Ulbricht have spent the last 2 months shifting the focus from their client, charged with creating the billion-dollar drug market, Silk Road, and putting it onto the potential illegality of the FBI's investigation. In a 38-page ruling on Friday, Judge Catherine Forrest dismissed the defense's motion to suppress evidence that hinged on the argument that law enforcement had violated Ulbricht's Fourth Amendment right to privacy from an unreasonable search. Just last week, Ulbricht's lawyers went so far as to contend that the FBI had illegally hacked a Silk Road server in Iceland without a warrant to determine the location. But the judge's rejection of that argument comes down to what may be seen as a fateful technicality. She argues that even if the FBI did hack the Silk Road server, Albrecht had not sufficiently demonstrated that the server belonged to him and thus can't claim that his privacy rights were violated by its search. She wrote, "Defendant has brought what he must certainly understand is a fatally deficient motion to suppress evidence. He has failed to take the one step he needed to allow the court to consider his claim regarding the investigation. He has failed to submit anything establishing that he has a personal privacy interest in the Icelandic server or any of the other items imaged and or searched and or seized." That argument may seem like a catch-22. If Albrecht were to claim ownership of that server, he would seem to incriminate himself, but Forrest writes that Albrecht could have nonetheless claimed the server in a pretrial statement that could not be used against him as evidence. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Reuters reports thousands of protesters marched through St. Louis on Saturday as part of a weekend of demonstrations against police violence organized after the fatal shooting of an unarmed teenager by a police officer over the summer. After a peaceful half-mile march through downtown, protesters rallied at Kiner Plaza. Organizers included Hands Up United, an activist group that emerged after the August 9th shooting of 18-year-old Michael Brown in suburban Ferguson, Missouri. Civil rights organizations and protest groups have invited people from around the country to join vigils and marches in the St. Louis area from Friday to Monday. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A majority of Americans are pointing to Friday's tragedy as a clear call for major reforms in everything, or literally anything at all that might prevent acts of horrifying, senseless violence. According to a recent ONN poll, the nation is united in saying that the key to preventing future tragedies is a drastic change in gun control, mental health care, school security, media coverage, violent entertainment, the fragility of the human condition, and really so many other things we probably haven't even thought of yet. Jesus. The Randolph Center for Public Health and Safety also released a statement saying, quote, "If you look at statistics regarding gun violence in the United States, you'll see the recent shooting is a clear cry for any thing at all to please, please be different." In Washington, lawmakers have reached a bipartisan agreement that the U.S. desperately needs tighter firearm restrictions or looser firearm restrictions, or honestly, whatever option just makes these things stop. Do that one.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, the live Sunday edition. Tonight, it's me, Stephanie, with you.
And Brian.
And Mark.
We are live here on Sunday night, and Free Talk Live is a show where you can call in, take control of the airwaves. Maybe you've never called a talk radio show before. Well, we have an open phones policy, so we invite you to weigh in with your thoughts on whatever's on your mind. We do have some stories we're going to get to tonight, talk about here, including a controversial billboard that's been ordered to be taken down by a hotel, apparently. We'll find out what that's all about in a moment. But I want to give you the opportunity tonight to call in about anything that you're thinking about that you want to talk about and discuss with us at 855-450-3733. That's 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. Here on Free Talk Live, we also have Skype, and our Skype ID is lrn.fm. You can also call the show that way. But let's get right into this billboard, Brian. What's been going on in New York City?
Yeah, well, this story comes from RT, I should say, RT.com. And it's Down and Out Pornhub Forced, and that's, yes, that Pornhub, as in Pornhub.com. Forced,
which is one of the biggest adult sites on the internet.
Yeah, it may
right?
be the largest adult site on the internet. And they have been forced to take down controversial billboard in Times Square. So Pornhub has been forced to remove a giant billboard it had erected.
Ba-dum-tsh. Oh, they had to throw that one in there, huh?
In New York Times Square, with it mysteriously disappearing from the area just hours only hours after it was put up. In May, Pornhub launched a headline-grabbing design competition, with entrants submitting a variety of images and slogans for their forthcoming advertisements, including one depicting a woman questioning a man, "What are you watching?" with the response, "Nothing," prompting the tagline, "The world's biggest archive of nothing," which is, that's kind of clever. Cute. Yeah, yeah. So they came up with some really clever ones. It's they definitely kind of, thought this through.
I mean, it's kind of playing on the cultural stereotype of like the guy like secretly watching porn while his
right.
female significant other's like, "What are you doing?" You
yeah.
know, the bad cop kind of, "Don't do that."
Yeah. So in total, more than 3,000 submissions were offered up by willing entrants. The sign reading, "All you need is hand," with a picture of a person's pair of hands coming together to form a heart shape, was designed by Nuri Gelver, an Istanbul. Wow. Sorry. Istanbul-based copywriter. So that's interesting. They're somebody out of Istanbul in Turkey. The 54-foot Safe for Work advertising was put up on Wednesday. To celebrate the occasion, Gotham Rock Choir performed an a cappella Pornhub-related adaptation of the Beatles' hit All You Need Is Love. Later in the day...
That's not love.
Yeah, that's...
That's not it.
Right. It later emerged that the sign was removed because of complaints from the Hilton Doubletree Hotel upon which the advert was mounted. Ba-dum-tsh. Our initial.
You know, what's worse, stories about marijuana or stories about porn with the puns that they just weave into the story?
Well, you know, if you're going to write it, you might as well, you know, stick one in there. Ba-dum-bum.
Oh.
Whoa, man, it just won't stop. Our initial agreement with City Outdoors.
It's got stamina.
Yeah.
It's really hard to write these articles.
Yeah. Yeah, never mind. All right.
The company, this is a very dangerous set of puns.
The company that owns the billboard space was that we had full approval for the ad to be placed in the initial location, a spokesman told BuzzFeed. So essentially, City Outdoor.
Tried clearing it with the hotel before they put this ad up.
They cleared it with City Outdoor, which I don't know that's the Hilton.
That's different.
Right.
But so, they. Go ahead.
Well, they've got these, they've got these billboards, and they put up an approved advertisement, and then the building upon which the ad is placed, who normally wouldn't care because, you know, they've already rented the space out or whatever, says, "Whoa, you're going just a little too far for us. We've got all kinds of families staying here, and here you have a picture of somebody holding up two hands.
Yeah.
We can't have that. What if kids start asking questions about making heart shapes with your hands?"
Yeah.
So, okay, this sounds like basically it's a property rights issue, right?
All that's true. It's just this is an uptight issue, too.
Yeah, in that, too. Also, I mean, if you're going to have an ad for an online porn site, I think it's pretty tasteful what they've actually done with that. It's not it's not a suggestive picture. Like, okay, we just got back from Las Vegas, Brian and I, because we were there for a Bitcoin convention last weekend. And you drive around Las Vegas and there's just all these pictures of, you know, strippers and cleavage and all kinds of stuff all over the billboards. I suppose you could say you expect that because it's Las Vegas. But when a company that is of an adult nature can advertise in a suggestive way, but not a like tacky way or not a very obvious way, that's pretty cool. Like, it's creative. It's almost like a burlesque show because they're kind of teasing your mind into thinking of something naughty or dirty without really actually just putting it all out there.
Yeah, I think it's very clever. I'm very impressed with this campaign. Been doing advertising for more than a decade. This is great, in my opinion. There's always going to be somebody that's going to have a complaint if, you know, Pornhub gets to advertise. We had a situation actually here on Free Talk Live where we had Adam and Eve, and that is it's a company that sells, you know, big purple rubber ding dongs and stuff like that. And yeah,
adult toys and right, adult materials.
I think they sell more than that.
Marital aids, right? And,
yes.
You know, I mean, married people and unmarried people buy things from this company. And they had a very tasteful ad they put together. I listened because when they said they wanted to advertise, I'm like, send the ad.
You know, yeah. Like, yeah.
I had nothing to say except send the ad. And I wanted to know what the ads were going to sound like. I listened to them. I listened again. I heard nothing that I could find objectionable.
Mm-hmm.
So we played them. Then A station at the time, and this has been some time ago, we didn't have as many stations back then, a station got a complaint. They're like, whoa, you're going to have to remove the porn advertisement from your airwaves. And I said, have you listened?
Yeah.
And he said, no.
That's the thing about those.
All right, go ahead and listen.
That's the thing about those community standards. It's different in every community, huh?
But he listened, and he said, okay, you can leave it on. He sided with with Free Talk Live and Adam and Eve on this, just saying that, look, there's always going to be somebody that's like, you can't advertise that.
Yeah.
No.
Well, that's encouraging to hear. But did you ever get any complaints? For a while, I know there was a gun manufacturer that was advertising on Free Talk Live.
No one ever complained about the gun manufacturer. Right.
Well,
so you
both
can
of these things are tools to accomplish certain ends, you know.
But I'm just saying that it's very interesting. In the first week, we get a complaint about a very tastefully done company that sells marital aids. Mm-hmm. And, when the gun manufacturer is on for months,
indeed,
years, actually, they were doing overtime, but they do seasonal stuff before that. But they were on for months. And
yeah,
no
body
one ever said
armor,
anything.
Also, yeah, you know, sure. Survivalist stuff.
Absolutely.
I mean, someone somewhere might be having fun. That's like the definition of Puritanism, right?
Yeah, well, I mean, the part that confuses me is I grew up for some time in New York City, and I don't understand at all. You know, walking down the street, there's neon signs saying, you know, quarter peep show, or at the time it was 5 cent peep show.
You can't get to peep it much.
No, sure, right.
What
but I mean,
peep for five
but there's,
cents?
Yeah. You know, triple X. I mean, like, there was no way you weren't recognizing sex was on sale somewhere here. And hey, at least Pornhub's giving it to you for free. But regardless,
how do they make money doing that, Brian?
Well, they have a premium subscription. I don't want to get too much into that because that'll make it, that might implicate me. No.
You know what? I'm not one of those women who will be upset if significant other is watching porn. I probably would want to join in.
But this is the thing. I would see those neon signs way before, and believe me, they're still there. We've been to New York City recently. You'd see them way before you'd notice this sign, but no one's telling those people to take their stuff down. What's the deal? I get the feeling, I mean, it's so, you know, to just take it down within hours of it happening and no questions asked, I almost feel like it was meant to be a news story. Literally they wanted it to get
media
attention.
Oh, man, that's
another
angle I hadn't considered.
Yeah, that was my point on this, is that they certainly got, they got more out of it than they would have gotten just by leaving it up.
Sure.
It's a very clever ad, and lots of people would see it in New York City, there's no doubt about it, but it's a national news story, and Pornhub appeals to people all around the globe, so I'd rather have the news than the bulletin board. Billboard. It depends on the size, actually. I think they do call some of them bulletin boards.
Yeah, I mean, this
size
is,
matters, Mark.
Sure. This is classic, you know, rock and roll kind of advertising where you get a lot of good press just on the fact that, you know, something like you got
that
censored.
Something's controversial.
Yeah, that something's controversial and you got censored for it. So.
Do you think Doubletree would be in on this, though? I mean, that's
hard to
maybe
believe.
Maybe they fell into the trap. What do you think? Call us 855-450-3733.
The honey
clever
trap.
Clever advertising ploy, honey trap, or something else. It's Free Talk Live. There's more coming up. 855-450-FREE.
Talk radio generally, and Free Talk Live specifically, are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing the proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
Beautiful Bellawood flooring just got even better with twice the scratch resistance and four times the abrasion resistance of other brands. And right now, Lumber Liquidators has exclusive deals on Bellawood with savings up to 40%. Choose from over 140 varieties, including Brazilian cherry, American walnut, even Bellawood's hot new matte finish that gives you that oil-finished look without all the maintenance, all with a transferable 100-year warranty. So go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest you. First ever 36-month financing is available. But hurry, these amazing deals end Tuesday.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237 and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Hey,
who do you think you are?
Excuse me. There is no video and audio allowed in this.
No, I have work today.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me.
What am I being detained
now.
For?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency, and Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, use it, and spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. This is the live Sunday night edition. Tonight, it's me, Stephanie.
And Brian.
And Mark.
We're glad you're joining us tonight. Free Talk Live is a show where you can call and bring up anything that's on your mind. We were talking about this billboard, this controversial billboard for Pornhub advertising a website.
Yeah, hands in the shape of a heart. I mean, very controversial.
Hands in the shape of a heart. You wouldn't think it would be controversial, but apparently it was, which was taken down in New York City. But you can call about that or anything else that's on your mind tonight at 855-450-3733. That's 855-450-3733. Free here on Free Talk Live, the Sunday night show. Also want to invite you to connect with us on social media. Join our email list if that's something you're into at news.freetalklive.com.
You know, something that really is controversial, though, is what the NSA and various companies like Facebook, etc., are doing every day to people's privacy around the world, let alone in the United States alone. And if this is something you're concerned about, okay, I want you to check out the Hack the Trackers event. If you think privacy is dead, well, not if, frankly, as many people as possible have anything to say about it. On November 7th and 8th, coders, privacy specialists, IDEA people of all stripes, they're going to join together for Hack the Trackers, transparency and privacy hackathon brought to you by Ghostery. And Ghostery, boy, if you don't know about Ghostery, that is an extension you want for your browser. Great for protecting your privacy. But you can enter online or join them in person in New York City, create tools that make the web a more transparent place, or help users manage how much data they share. Hacks will be judged by experts and voted on by an online community, and winners will receive a prize package, including the all-new Black Phone, a secure by design smart.
I want to go just for that.
Yeah. I want that.
Yeah, the Black Phone's pretty cool. This is actually designed by Phil Zimmerman, who is the creator of PGP, which is about as rock solid as encryption as we could possibly have.
The only encryption that hasn't been broken for 20 years.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, it was broken like once, but they fixed it almost overnight. So anyway, participation is free and registration registration is open now. Visit hackthetrackers.com for more information on that. I'm telling you, this is a great event, and this is really important stuff that people are doing. If you want to support something, this is something to support.
Are you going to go to that event?
I don't believe I will be attending it. It was offered, but I'm not sure.
Okay. So.
All right. Straight from the mouth of the golden stallion of the tech world.
That's right.
HackTheTrackers.com. And our number one more time tonight, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733 here on Free Talk Live. Or you can call us on Skype at lrn.fm. I want to actually get into another story, Mark, that you had brought in. This is about an unusual traffic stop, right?
Yes.
Tell me more about that.
The Indiana State Police pulled a woman over, Ellen Bogan. And Ellen Bogan expects police to protect and serve, not proselytize. This comes from the IndyStar.com. She says Indiana State Police Trooper Brian Hamilton pitched Christianity to her when he pulled her over for an alleged traffic violation in August on U.S. 27 in Union County.
Pitched Christianity to her?
With the lights on, his marked police car still flashing, the trooper handed Bogan a warning ticket. Then, Bogan said, Hamilton posed some personal questions. Did she have a home church? Did she accept Jesus as her savior?
What?
It's completely out of line.
Officer, I don't think I'm required to answer these questions.
And it just took me aback, Bogan said. 60, she told the Indianapolis Star.
Am I free to go?
Star.
Am I being detained? Well, you're in purgatory until you accept Jesus into your heart, little lady. Let's find out more about this here in moments. But first, I want to go to the phones because Free Talk Live is the show where you can call in and take control of the airwaves. Nick from South Carolina is listening. Hey, Nick, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind tonight?
I was wondering your opinion on the validity of making a federal inmate do his drug time while making the state of South Carolina wait until he's finished his time for drugs before they can prosecute him for two, not one, but two murders.
I would have thought that was very dangerous. I would think that would be illegal. I mean, that there should be should be taken to court and given his trial, and then he can finish up his drug time if that's what needs to happen. But I've never heard of something like that.
Well, it was disturbing to me in that the federal government seems to elevate illegal drugs over taking a person's life.
That's what it looks like. Yeah,
I mean, sounds like.
What else is there to say about it? So did the person murder some people and was also doing drug deals and then got incarcerated for drugs and then the murder was just never prosecuted and now they are putting it on hold?
They're putting it on hold. They have the arrest warrant.
Wow. So, I mean.
I'm surprised.
Yeah, I mean, what else is there to say about it? What do you think about these drug laws? It sounds like you're not a fan.
Well, they're irrational. I don't know if they're good or bad, but I know they're irrational. And
yeah.
This is an example of holding something completely irrational over something concrete like taking a person's life.
Government is not known for being rational, and I thank you for the call tonight, Nick.
Yeah,
interesting. Their strong suit. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, clearly, I think it's very clear anyway that the U.S. government, be it at the state, whatever level of government, doesn't have a problem with people getting killed. If they had an issue with that, maybe their foreign policy would look a whole lot different, or maybe various servants of the state wouldn't be so quick to be shooting people, let alone even dogs and other things. They wouldn't be so trigger happy.
Yeah, indeed. So, priorities. I just saw an article today about the military was considering a smoking ban. Like, so if you're on duty in the military, you can't be smoking cigarettes, but the irony is like, okay, they don't want them to die from cigarettes, but they don't mind putting them in the line of fire.
Let them catch some bullets.
Killing other people. I mean, clearly it's not the death that's the problem to that organization.
Maybe. I have a friend who said that he was in the Navy, and the reason he started smoking cigarettes was because it seemed like everybody in the Navy smoked cigarettes, and if he wanted to be able to take those smoke breaks like they got, that he had to smoke, essentially.
You better pick up the habit. Yeah.
Right. So his, and I don't know what the ranks are in the Navy, but his warrant officer or whatever, when he tried to take breaks with everybody else, it's like, what are you doing here? Well, taking a break. you're not smoking. Get back to work. So, you know, he felt incentivized, essentially, to begin smoking.
Oh, yeah, that sounds exactly like an incentive.
Yeah, I mean, that incentive exists out of the military, too, of course. I've been in plenty of workplaces where, you know, people who smoke, they get to, like, take a break 5 minutes on the hour every hour. Or, you know, as to where the normal person that doesn't smoke only gets 15 minutes every, like, 5 hours or 4 hours or something. I mean, it's pretty ridiculous.
I remember there was this episode of the show Friends. It was a sitcom where Rachel had this job at her workplace or something like that, where everybody else was smoking, and they were having basically meetings when everybody else went for a smoke break, and they were making important decisions on their smoke break, and they'd get back inside and they'd made some important decision without her.
They just let her know.
So she decided to fake that she was a smoker so she could be in on these meetings. And I mean, it's that really actually does happen.
I think it happens far less than it used to. The percentage of the population that smokes is going down.
Yeah,
it used to be cool. It is not cool anymore.
No. Yeah, that's for sure.
You know, you're out there by the dumpster in the freezing cold just trying to puff on the cigarette. But I do think that people were incentivized in the past, and, you know, that's a shame.
Well, now with people trying to switch to e-cigarettes, that might be thwarted by the government banning those pretty soon. So
it's ridiculous. You're
always looking out for your best interests, folks. 855-450-FREE. Have you tried to quit smoking lately? Or got an opinion on the preaching cop? Let us know. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
What good is a Big Berkey water filter?
We get that question a lot here at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. And in a word, the answer is protection. Protection from water main breaks, E. coli contamination, environmental chemical spills, pesticide runoff, chlorine taste and smell, and all forms of fluoride. Plus, Big Berkey water filters are the original gravity water filter system and most trusted on the market for a reason. Tested by multiple independent NSF EPA certified labs, they are the gold standard in water purification. At only 1.7 cents a gallon, a single set of filters can last for 5 to 10 years. That means big savings. Big Berkey, the one that's powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. Get a Big Berkey today at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. GCN listeners receive 5% off all ceramic filter systems. Visit our website or call 1-877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
If you're looking for work, you know what I mean by elevator speech. It's the short version, saying just enough to make the listener want to listen more. Even if you're not a job seeker, effective communication skills have never been more important, with money and attention so scarce now. So to cut through the clutter, choose every single word as though it was the last word the person you're speaking to will hear. Otherwise, it might be. Instead of saying, due to the fact that, say, because, and avoid mispronunciations. Say jewelry, not jewelry, which could offend. Undoubtedly, you don't want to say undoubtedly. And whatever you do, never use a preposition to end a sentence with. Just kidding. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
You are listening to Free Talk Live, the live Sunday night show. It's me, Stephanie, here.
And Brian.
And Mark.
You can call us tonight at 855-450-3733. Bring up anything that's on your mind. We've been talking about a preaching cop, quitting smoking, and a controversial billboard. But you can bring up anything that's on your mind tonight at 855-450-3733. That's 855-450-FREE, the word free. You can also call us on Skype at lrn.fm. And those phone lines, of course, are brought to you by ProXPN.
Yeah, ProXPN is a VPN service, and you know, you really should have one if you're going to be surfing the internet, because there's all kinds of viruses out there. You need a prophylactic for the internet.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you never know if you're going, if you're traveling. We were just traveling quite a bit, and if you're going to the Burger King or McDonald's or whatever, and you're connecting to their Wi-Fi, or if you're going to the airport and you're connecting to their Wi-Fi, there's so many just chances for your computer to get, you know, for your privacy to get, go ahead.
Yeah, people don't know it, but people can intercept, you know, bad guys or bad gals can intercept your internet traffic if you're on those open Wi-Fi networks like you might find at a coffee shop or something like that. That's why you need something like ProXPN, because you don't want to be logging into your bank account to check it, or your Bitcoin wallet, perhaps, and
right,
have somebody else seeing what passwords you're typing in or what information you're sending.
Yes. So what you want to do is you want to encrypt all of the data and metadata that you send up from your computer, smartphone, or tablet before it even gets to, you know, the router. You want it done what they call client side, okay? And you want this done with OpenVPN, which is an open source VPN backend that ProXPN uses. So with all of that in mind, you want to be using ProXPN if you care about your digital privacy. Now you can go to proxpn.com, use the code FTL50. You'll get 50% off the annual price of the account. It's going to end up costing you less than a cup of coffee a month. I mean, this is really, and speaking of which, the coffee shop's one of those places where you really want to have your VPN on.
Exactly.
Okay, very important. But also, they love Bitcoin at ProXPN, and so if you want to use Bitcoin, you can actually get 62% off the price of an annual account. And if you use the code FTLBTC, as in Bitcoin, FTLBTC. So use either of those codes, FTL50 or FTLBTC. Get this VPN. Take charge of your privacy. It's your right. And you can get it back with this very easy to use and install software. So ProXPN.com.
All right. We use it. We like it. ProXPN.com.
Yeah, I love it.
FTL50 or FTLBTC are the codes. 855-450-FREE is our phone number here on Free Talk Live. That's 855-450-3733. In case you're just tuning in, we've been talking about a cop who pulled a woman over in, where was it, Idaho?
No, it was Indiana.
Indiana. All these states that start with I's get me confused. So, woman's driving down the road in Indiana. She gets pulled over. She sees the blue lights in her windshield. But what happened next, she didn't expect, which was that the cop started asking her if she had accepted Jesus into her heart.
Yeah, that's I can see why she's very surprised at this. I mean, this isn't what you would expect from a traffic stop.
It's never happened to me.
And obviously the police aren't going to be commenting on this because it's, you know, in the midst of pending litigation and the ACLU is involved and all that stuff.
Mark, what would you do if that happened to you?
Well, you know, I like this conversation because, you know, I'm 43. I have spent my life sort of unwrapping the indoctrination I got as a kid. And everything you get's indoctrination unless you get no doctrination, right? You know, that's what it is. So whatever anybody's religion is what it is, and that's fine. But I think there's a certain personality type that can take it very seriously. And I did. I took it all very seriously. And I like, for instance, in the shower, I'm having conversations with an imaginary God at the end of time, explaining to him why his judgment day system stinks, right? Like, I'm that bananas about, and, you know, kind of like a kind of person who talks to myself. I call it rehearsing.
Well, just think about that, though. I mean, how many people talk to God in the shower, and it's like, yeah, you don't find that kind of creepy? Like, that there's someone in the shower with you?
I've got I got a little time. Well, some people believe there's angels in there watching over you, too.
That's true.
People believe lots of things like that. Yes, they do.
I find these conversations to be interesting, so I probably would just try to debate him on the issues that he puts forth.
Are you nervous about the idea of debating a cop? You know, like, I would personally, I like to get out of those situations as fast as I can. Like, the less I can interact with them, the better, because that interaction is based on force. The only reason I pulled over is because I'm scared of what will happen to me if I don't pull over. The only reason I reply to anything that they say is because I'm scared of what will happen if I don't reply. So, that interaction is not voluntary in any way, and I just want to end it as quickly as possible.
I understand how and why sane and normal people would operate differently than I do, but no.
Are you calling me normal? I'm offended.
It's normal to want to be out of that situation. However, it would probably do me some real good if I have a audio and video record, which I do, of everything that goes on in my car. Check out freedomcam.net. And if I have an audio video record of a police officer disagreeing with me on a religious point and then deciding that I need to go to jail. Like, I really want that to happen as a nationally syndicated talk show host.
That would be some great content.
If I could get one of my law enforcement friends to work that out, I understand your career is probably ruined, but I don't care. It would be really good for mine.
Hey, the taxpayers will pay for the lawsuit judgment anyway. So
what exactly happened to this? Like, did she get away?
Thank you, Brian. I'm curious too.
She got a warning.
A warning.
But
okay.
He did hand her a church pamphlet that asks the reader to acknowledge that she is a sinner.
Wow.
So, yeah, see, you know, I can't help but feel that if this was getting asked of me, now I don't know in which order that happened, but I mean, thankfully she was just given a warning. But if I was given anything more than a warning, I'd have a hard time not believing this wasn't profiling. Okay, like this wasn't, or not maybe profiling is too strong a word, but he was judging what I did based upon the fact whether or not I'm a Christian.
Yeah, I mean, and how would someone be able to tell that? Like, maybe you have a Darwin fish bumper sticker on the back of your car or something. Maybe you have a flying spaghetti monster T-shirt on or something.
There are probably as many as a percentage atheists that are vocal about their atheism as there are Christians that are vocal about their Christianity.
No.
No?
No.
I find atheists to be, in many cases, very, very vocal.
Okay, I have statistics on this for you.
Okay.
So the last time I heard, this is from, I think you guys mentioned it on Free Talk Live a couple nights ago. Go back in the archives at archives.freetalklive.com if you want to check on this. But it was in 2012, and there was the Pew Foundation does a poll about religiosity every 10 years or something like that in America. So what they found was that 77% of Americans identified as Christian. 14% had no religious affiliation at all.
Yep.
And okay, so the atheists are going to be in that 14%,
right?
The Christians are going to be in that 77%.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, there are outspoken atheists, but if we think about the percentage of people that are outspoken across both of those groups, it would seem like there would be way more Christians because they're just way more Christians, period.
I don't think most Christians, like, you're talking about 77%.
Way more outspoken.
And I said as a percentage of the populations. But
well, I missed that.
Yes. So, I will agree that there are more outspoken Christians simply because there are a vast.
Yeah, I think atheists definitely get more press. Like, they get more because they'll say the more incendiary things. I would say, but in that same framework, I would say that Muslims certainly are the loudest by, you know, as far as there's not more Muslims, but I think they get, you know, a Muslim says something, it's in the news, okay, as far as the press.
Because I was going to say, I've never seen a bumper sticker on the back of a car promoting Islam.
But that's because
people
are
probably scared to advertise it.
Sure, but that's because Muslims are being vilified unjustly at that.
They weren't really before 9/11, so you'd think that I would remember that, and I don't remember anything like that, you know.
Yeah.
Sure. But then I think atheists, too, are often getting put into the, you know, into the fore to often
get
vilified.
Too.
Yeah.
I mean, this story happened in Indiana, right?
Bible Belt.
I couldn't imagine this happening in Massachusetts or California.
Oh, I think you could find this is really bad form by a police officer, and I think you could find a nutty police officer. Because at this point, what this guy's trying to do is he's trying to save her immortal soul. His job is inconsequential to that woman's soul. And I've got to say, you know, kudos to somebody who's willing to put their job on the line in this way. But
what would you do?
It's not acceptable.
What would you do if a cop started preaching at you? 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live, the Sunday show.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right, that's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Free Talk Live.
It's not just zoning rules, it's everything.
It's true.
It's everything. There's so many laws. You can't possibly know them. It's physically an impossibility to know the laws. You know not to hurt other people. I don't need a law telling me to do that. But the rest of them? Totally inaccessible.
It's true.
It's written in legalese. If you don't have training in reading that crap, it might as well be a foreign language. Mm. And as you pointed out, it doesn't matter if you can read it.
I thought I had them dead to rights. And these bureaucrats, they just we do whatever we want here at the zoning board.
Yeah, that's right.
And you'll kiss our butts.
Peon. Surf.
You'll slave. You'll do what we say.
Yeah. Why label them citizens?
Oh.
Why not just call it what it is? You're a serf. You're a slave.
Free Talk Live. 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern. Live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges. Yeah!
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live, the live Sunday night show. This is the show where you can call and take control of the airwaves, bring up anything that's on your mind, from preaching cops to controversial billboards, to the persecution of atheists and Muslims, perhaps. You've got opinions, you can share them at 855-450-3733, the Pro-XPN toll-free call-in lines. But we're going to have a conversation with you, of course. We don't just want to hear your opinions, we want to talk about them, too. That's what Free Talk Live is all about. So 855-450-FREE, that's 855-450-3733. Or you can call on Skype at lrn.fm on Skype. I'd like to switch gears here and talk about an article that you brought in, Mark, about, oh no, it was you, Brian, I'm sorry. Why are there restaurants that still only accept cash?
Oh, sure. I'll just have to punch that one up.
Oh, sure, no problem. Well, I mean, I know that I have an idea why there are still restaurants that only accept cash. Well, I think the author of the
article... There's a lot of fees on credit cards, I think is one of the reasons.
Yeah, that was one of the reasons I had in mind. I think the author of the article is going to imply that there are all these shady establishments avoiding taxes. But certainly credit card fees could be a reason as well. So have you been to a restaurant lately that only accepted cash? Because not everybody carries cash nowadays.
It's been a while.
They should warn you. Like, if they only accept cash, they should definitely put up a sign to warn you and say, look, we don't take credit cards. Because in a lot of places, people are used to just walking around with only their credit cards in their wallet and no cash.
I think a sign's a good idea, but I would like to point out that not everybody sees signs. I just don't pay that much attention to signage.
Fair enough.
I just kind of ignore it.
You learn to filter it out because you do see a lot of advertising and signage on a daily basis. It's true.
You know, most of the rules don't apply to me. I'm not gonna dance on your table. Not gonna try to build a sandcastle in the middle of
there, Mark.
Yeah. So here's a story from Gothamist.com, which is pretty popular for getting to know New York City, and it's a good commentary on the city. It has a lot of differing views, so keep that in mind. But anyway, this is from their segment, Ask a Native New Yorker. What's the deal with cash-only restaurants? And it's, I'll skip. There's like an introduction to the guy who does this Ask the New Yorker thing, you know, showing his street cred, more or less. But here's the question that gets asked of him, and it's, hey, Jake, why are there so many cash-only restaurant businesses in New York? Besides avoiding the draconian fees charged by the credit card companies, is there another explanation? Is this a giant cover-up to protect the profits of our city's ATM installation companies? Is cash still king?
You know, I'm curious about that, but hold that thought, Brian.
All right.
We're going to go to the phones and talk with Todd. He's actually on the road. And Todd, you said you have a similar story to what happened to this woman who got pulled over and had a cop proselytize to her. Tell us about that.
Yes, to a certain degree. I just picked you guys up driving through Tioga.
And, can you repeat that? What did you just say?
Oh, I was just driving through town, and I picked you up on the radio station. Can you hear me okay?
Oh, yes. Thank you. Yeah, we're glad you're here. So tell us what happened with this cop.
Well, I want to first tell you, I think you guys are really boring.
We're boring? Why do you keep listening?
The men sound kind of effeminate. They don't have very masculine voices. I'm just curious. are there any gay men on the panel?
I don't know that it matters.
Yeah, what's it to you?
That guy right there. He sounds very effeminate. I'm just
curious. Well, that's Mark. He's got a name.
Well, I mean, just picture that. If you're gay, you're somebody that's interested in men. I mean, how manly do you have to be to get it on with men? I mean, that's serious.
What's wrong with that? Are you opposed to it?
No, of course not.
Oh, okay. I just wanted to tell you, I think you guys are really boring.
Yep, okay. You said that already. Okay. Do you have a story you want to share with us about your pullover?
And the subjects that you bring up are just, you have like a, you're trying to be real intellectual, but you're not.
Well, wait a second. How long have you listened to the show?
About 5 minutes. I have to be able to, the only way for me to voice my opinion is to hear what you guys sound like. So I do have to listen to you in order to formulate an opinion.
Understood, but you talk about the subjects we bring up and we try to sound intellectual. I mean, if you've been listening for 5 minutes, it seems like a pretty snap judgment.
Got it all figured out.
Well, I can tell. I mean, it's just obvious.
Well, I think you're, here, let me
well,
challenge,
Todd, you can
let me
make
challenge
it more
your
interesting.
Opinion, Todd. We're on 166 radio stations. We've been doing it for 12 years. We're growing all the time. Revenue continues to grow. Well, like, ooh.
Oh, you're
but
making
like,
a lot of money.
No, I'm not making a lot of money. I probably
you're
don't
impressive.
Make much more than you.
You're an impressive man.
I'm just pointing out that you're wrong, dude.
Todd,
the
thanks
fact
for the call.
Is that the show continues to grow. It wouldn't grow if it was boring.
Indeed. Mark,
it
don't
like,
feed the trolls.
It sounds like somebody got their butt hurt over something. I don't know what.
Who knows what's going on.
Maybe anyway, I'm wrong. Maybe I'm just boring.
Let's
and
talk,
gay.
Let's talk to Don in Texas. Don, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Well, I was just calling as a first-time listener, and I never heard of that. That's definitely a new one. I suppose I'd rather have that question fired at me by a police officer than his sidearm.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, well, that's for sure.
Happen.
Well, if it's a choice between those two, yeah.
Jesus saves, huh?
But only takes half damage.
So what's right, on your what else is on your mind, Don?
I understand that you were saying that you're an atheist.
I don't know if we said that tonight. Yeah, I would consider myself an atheist. I think, Brian, you would. Mark,
yes.
You would not,
no.
Right? Okay, Mark is a theist.
Okay, yeah. You think life only, does life exist maybe only on Earth and all the universe?
Oh, I would say that's a pretty wild claim there.
Well, my interpretation of the Bible is such to say that, well, you know, God, extraterrestrial, alien, if you will, plurality, called in some ancient tablets, the Anunnaki, came from space and made life on Earth.
Now you've really gone up Brian's alley.
No.
Brian is kind of an expert on Zachariah Sitchin, who he was a...
You compare notes to other religions, though, you know, you have to get off into symbolical allegory and underinterpreting other religions and their symbols and stuff. I mean, they can see the crescent moon in Hinduism is as much as you see it in a...
Sure. You know, it's an interesting idea, right? The idea that extraterrestrials may have seeded life on Earth. I mean, and when you read the Bible, it does get very interesting that from the beginning, who is God talking to when he says, let's make him in our image? Who? You know, like, who is this plural person that he's talking to? Sorry, go ahead, caller.
That would be the Anunnaki just... making
right now man. Anunnaki is a Sumerian term which means from heaven to earth
this.
Came okay now granted though here while we're talking about this I personally have a theory. I think that a lot of the cuneiform and even Sitchin, who came up with a lot of this theory about the Anunnaki along with Eric von Daniken, they admit that it's tough to translate some of this stuff, and that's why a lot of people, they would say, got it wrong. And so I think Anunnaki can just as well, because the Anunnaki came from Nibiru, and so now Sitchin and a lot of people would say that Nibiru is this planet that swoops in. Sitchin called it the 12th planet, actually.
By the way, okay. Is this guy we mentioned, Zachariah Sitchin, was a researcher who translated the ancient Sumerian cuneiform tablets,
yeah,
and said that they basically told the story of a race of extraterrestrials called the Anunnaki, mm-hmm, who created humans.
Right. Now, whether he's right or wrong, he was right way ahead of his time on a lot of things, and that's weird. Okay, because
I mean, what was the cloud by day, the fire by night? The Israelites followed out of Egypt. I mean, I'd say UFOs, so called, are very much a part of the Bible.
Sure. Well, you know, but here's what I want to posit to you is that perhaps when they're talking about Nibiru, there's actually a word very similar to Nibiru in Sumerian, which means it doesn't mean heaven or like from the heavens. It actually means from a far off land. And so I've often wondered that instead of the Anunnaki being aliens, if they were just like some kind of advanced humans from a far off land, and that they did, you know, but I mean, they still could have had high tech or something like that.
Yeah.
Honestly, at the end of the day,
Don, thank you for calling.
Yeah.
I appreciate your thoughts on this. It's a very interesting topic.
No, it is. I mean, then they call it the ancient astronaut theory. I don't really subscribe to it. Okay. But to me, it holds as much validity as any religion out there, because you're all running off of very scant information, and in some degrees, even faith. Because like the caller said, it's like, do you believe that there's people on other worlds, or, you know, there's aliens out there? I do, but I think it's an incredibly smaller number than what most people do.
Now, one thing we know with the Romans is that they were technologically far superior to, say, the barbarian tribes of Germany.
The Egyptians were incredibly advanced, right, especially with when it came to chemistry. I mean, they knew how to make formaldehyde to embalm mummies, and they knew how to make batteries, basically these electrical chambers.
They also created a steam engine. Hero did. Mm-hmm. But these societies would fall, and their technology would go away. There was a time when people were camping out, living their lives inside the Colosseum after, you know, the fall of Rome. Like, this was how far Rome had fallen.
Oh, sure. There's still tricks that, you know, like the Greek fire that the Byzantine Empire used. We still don't know how they pulled that off.
Hour number two of tonight's program is coming up, 855-450-3733. 855-450-FREE is the number here on Free Talk Live. Or should we call it Ancient Aliens? Bring up anything that's on your mind. It's Free Talk Live.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Little Jack Horner sat in a corner of his ransacked apartment, wondering what kind of nitwit steals a futon. Luckily, the Geico Insurance Agency had helped him with renter's insurance, and he got full replacement. Unfortunately, little Jack Horner had to have his stomach pumped when he ate a six-month-old Christmas pie. Visit geico.com to see how affordable renter's insurance can be.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, October 10th, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,229, silver around $17.56, and Bitcoin around $370. Today's precious metal prices are brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support for Liberty Beat comes from SovereignMiners.com. Interested in mining Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies? Well, Sovereign Miners has you covered. All purchases come with a free Script ASIC miner. Visit SovereignMiners.com to buy your miner today. In the news, on Wednesday, arguments concluded in a hearing on force feeding at the Guantanamo Bay military prison. Lawyers with Human Rights Group Reprieve represented Syrian detainee Abu Wa'il Diab in a hearing that will determine the legality of the force feeding and whether or not 32 videos of the procedure will be released to the public. Diab's team presented three expert witnesses, while the government failed to present any. Judge Gladys Kessler is expected to rule on the matter in the coming weeks. Thousands of demonstrators marched through Mexico's capital this week, calling on the government to investigate missing students and a recently discovered mass grave. 43 students went missing after a clash with police in Aguila in the state of Guerrero on September 26. A mass grave filled with burned human bodies was also found over the weekend. Guerrero's attorney general said it was probable that some of the 28 bodies found belonged to the missing students. On Monday, New York Supreme Court Justice Paul Wooten ruled that the high-rise safety initiative will not appear on the November 4th ballot. The initiative was an effort to investigate all high-rise collapses on or since September 11, 2001, including World Trade Center 7. Justice Wooten sided with a court-appointed referee's recommendations that the petition to be on the ballot be denied. However, the justice called the city's efforts to dismiss the case based on technicalities irrational and misplaced, and would lead to disenfranchisement of more than 30,000 registered voters without due process. Support for Liberty Beat comes from My Magic Mud, 100% natural teeth whitener, polishes teeth and detoxifies the mouth. Visit MyMagicMud.com to buy your jar of My Magic Mud today. Did you know you can support the Liberty Beat when shopping on Amazon.com? Well, you can. Simply log into your account after clicking our Amazon affiliate link at libertybeat.com, Amazon. That's right, you can help the Liberty Beat continue to deliver hard-hitting Liberty news and activist updates by doing your Amazon shopping after following our link at thelibertybeat.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, October 10th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. To celebrate both the Liberty Beat's new partnership with the Genesis Communications Network and alternative media in general, the Liberty Beat proudly invites you to Be the Media. This all-day event will happen Saturday, October 25th, at Brave New Books in Austin, Texas. Hosted by the Liberty Beat, in partnership with the Austin Agorist Alliance and Brave New Books. The event will be live-streamed so non-Austinites can also take part. The day will feature an intensive do-it-yourself journalism workshop, lectures, panel discussions, networking, a soapbox idol rant-off, and a launch party to celebrate the new partnership between the Liberty Beat and GCN. Confirmed speakers include Adam Kokesh of the Freedom Line, Michael Cargill of Come and Talk It, Heather Fazio of Texans for Accountable Government, Harlan Dietrich of The Crypto Show, Matthew Medina of Truth Exposed Radio, Joel Williamson of the Alliance of Austin Agorists, and the Liberty Beat's own Derek Bros, John Bush, and Catherine Bleich. If you're looking for a more intimate and intensive learning experience, you can join John Bush before the bookstore is even open to the public for a do-it-yourself journalism intensive crash course. This portion of the event has limited seating, and tickets will go on sale soon. Sign up to compete in the Soapbox Idol competition or pre-register for the morning workshop at thelibertybeat.com. Support our expansion while you learn how to be the media. See you at Brave New Books, Saturday, October 25th. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from The Corey Moore Show. With a focus on all things topical and liberty-oriented, Corey Moore and his band of co-hosts keep a sense of humor while attacking the state. It's The Corey Moore Show, live each Friday night, 9 o'clock Central, 10 o'clock Eastern, at CoreyMooreShow.com. This is The Liberty Beat for Friday, October 10th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
After briefly reviewing several documents outlining his parents' dire financial circumstances today, 23-year-old Wesleyan University graduate Zach Wallace told reporters he had, quote, absolutely no clue how his mother and father are going to dig themselves out of the $35,000 of student loan debt they incurred to pay for his college education.
I mean, this is going to be really hard on my parents. When I was in college, I just assumed that, you know, they would pay off my student loans within a few years of me graduating. But I never realized how expensive college is going to be for them.
Wallace, who graduated with a film studies degree in 2012 and has since had two unpaid internships, told reporters that from the way prevailing interest rates are trending, his parents could easily be paying off his debt for the next quarter century.
They're going to be paying for the rest of their lives. And on top of it all, they have to help me out with my rent, too. I mean, it sucks. It really, really sucks.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, tonight at 11. Just kidding. This is Free Talk Live, the live Sunday night edition with me, Stephanie.
And Brian.
And Mark.
Is this the first Sunday show where we've got the different music on? Maybe we should just address that.
I think it is the first Sunday show we've got the different music on.
Yeah, so a lot of people are wondering about that. Free Talk Live's music beds are a little different, but we are still the same show. You know, we just decided that this would be a better thing for Free Talk Live and hope you're enjoying it.
Influential consultant in the business that we hired to come in and, you know, give us some advice suggested that we change out the music beds. He made several good points as to why that should be done, including, you know, sort of copyright issues. You don't want to have that. You know,
and that when people tune into talk radio, they want it to be talk radio, not music radio.
Yep.
So. Yeah, personally, I like it.
I do too.
I mean, and please, you know, we had like heavy metal beds before, Megadeth and all that. And I am a huge metalhead. I mean, I love heavy metal. I listen to it all the time. And so, you know, I don't miss it. It's fine. I mean, yeah, I didn't come here for the metal, you know, and I think I can really see where like the kind of the attitude of the music, like just coming in, you know, kind of loud and hard, could turn off a lot of people, especially as we grow. You know, I mean, this show is really growing to many, many markets now.
Anyway, it is still the same show where you can call and bring up anything that's on your mind. We've been talking tonight about why there are restaurants that still only accept cash. We're going to get more into that in moments here. But first, I want to let you know how you can get in touch with us today. 855-450-3733 is our phone number here on Free Talk Live. That's 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. Or you can call us on Skype at lrn.fm. All right, Brian, let's hear some more about why there are restaurants in New York City that still only accept cash in 2014.
Sure. Now, this answer...
Why are they relying on this silly paper thing?
Right. Now, this article is, or the response to a question sent into the Gothamist, which is a, you know, a website paper about New York City itself. And so it's being responded to by a New York native, whatever that means. And here is his response as to why there's still restaurants that and businesses that only take cash in New York City. So I share your paranoia and feel that it is justified. Back by my old apartment, there was an Italian place that seemed to be doing great business, full from 6 p.m. till closing daily. It wasn't cheap either. We're talking $50 a person for an entree and a glass of wine. Yet it didn't take credit cards, and every night you'd see a procession of embarrassed diners caught short on cash walking up to the ATM at the local bodega 3 blocks away. That's a bad way to end a night in terms of customer experience, and since the place is clearly successful enough to afford the credit card charges, I figured that they must be running a tax scam, underreporting their sales to the state and pocketing the difference, maybe even laundering money for Brooklyn's last remaining gangsters or something.
Oh, seriously? That this person
wild
must be
conjecture.
Judge, yeah. Jury, and executioner. Seriously? Like, now if you use cash, if you don't accept credit cards, you're automatically a criminal.
Yeah.
And if you do accept credit cards, then you're innocent.
Yeah, absolutely. Well,
I mean, that logic just doesn't hold up.
Yeah, it kind of reminds me what happens if you don't have a Facebook account. Oh,
yeah,
you're
then
a sociopath.
You must be a sociopath.
You must be some sicko.
Must be something seriously wrong.
I wouldn't doubt for a second that you know, that some businesses that take cash are fudging the books or whatever. It doesn't really matter to me that much.
So are some businesses that take credit cards.
I consider that, you know, in starting with our founding fathers and many others, I consider tax dodgers to be patriots in many cases. I don't think every one of them is, but I think that you know, some of them are, certainly. So that doesn't matter to me.
I'm confused about something. What defines a patriot to you?
Somebody who believes in, you know, the principles that the country is founded on, right? Like,
what are those principles?
I don't know, for liberty and stuff. Admittedly, I'm pandering a little bit, right?
Okay, that's what I wanted.
But, you know, I mean, yeah, there's lots of great folks that have been tax dodgers. And
well, let's talk about this idea. Okay, taxes. Taxes is basically just a word for theft that's institutionalized, and everybody thinks it's okay. Everybody thinks it's necessary because that's what they've been told from the time that they're really young. Well,
wait a minute, you have to pay your taxes.
Nothing is certain except death and taxes.
You don't want to be protected? What's wrong with you? You don't enjoy paying for the U.S. military?
Well, I would like to make my own arrangements to protect myself in a voluntary way that doesn't involve someone else claiming that I owe them a portion of my paycheck, which reflects labor that I did.
There are some evil people out there. Okay.
Well, yes, including some of those people are in the U.S. government, and I don't necessarily want to pay them 30% of my paycheck. Yeah, 40,
obviously
50%.
I'm joking.
Yeah, I mean, not only do we have federal taxes, we've got state, local, town property taxes, water taxes, food taxes, restaurant, hotel taxes. Before you bat an eye, half of your income is basically taken from you. And when somebody else takes your income, whether it's 1%, 10%, or 100%, that's basically slavery. You're working not for yourself. You're working not to get the benefits of your own labor, but you're working to provide for someone else. And if you didn't agree to that, then it's slavery. It's not voluntary. So I really want to just hammer home that point. We're thinking about the concept of taxes all wrong. I mean, the question really should be, why does someone else have any kind of claim on your labor or your income? You know, if you want to give it to them, that's fine. If you want to do charity or spend it or save it, give it away, whatever you choose, that's okay. But why does someone else have a claim on it? And why are you bad for wanting to keep the money that you earned yourself? That's the question. 855-450-3733 is our number here on Free Talk Live.
So there's more to this. He actually, the columnist, goes and asks somebody that actually owns businesses and restaurants. So it goes on here. After I got your email, I asked a friend of mine who runs a bunch of popular retail establishments in a fast gentrifying part of town and for his thoughts on the phenomenon. I'll call him Pedro. He wrote back, any place, this is the response from the business owner, any place that doesn't accept cards or that has a minimum charge is running a mafioso-style business that screams they don't care about you. At our cafe, wow, especially, we hear all day expressions of surprise that they can pay for a coffee with a card. OMG, we prefer cards. We prefer cards. No cash to lose or get stolen or miscounted. A business that can't survive the 2% credit card charge is going out of business tomorrow anyway. Well, that's just not, CDB.
The business doesn't actually... I mean, there's no charge that the business is taking.
Yeah, they pass that cost on to their
customers. It has to be passed, necessarily is being passed on to the customer. So the suggestion this is mafioso, no, this is the way they want to run their business. I've certainly been to the mom and pop places that don't accept credit cards because they don't want to pay the fees. And let's not forget that these credit card companies will treat you like you're some kind of serf, like you're a dog on a leash.
Oh, yeah.
And it is no fun to be in business. You get in business in order to sort of run your life to some extent. And then, you know, these big banks, these giant payment systems operators are yanking you around and having you do whatever you want. You know what stinks as a restaurateur? To have your money locked up for 30, 60, or 90 days while they investigate something.
Oh, absolutely. The only mafia still around is the financial services businesses. You know, the credit card companies and all that. That's the only mafioso style business going around.
I'm aghast at the presumption of guilt here.
Yeah, there's a lot more here.
There's no possible way that someone could run a cash-only business and be legit and not be hurting others with crime or whatever?
Let me answer that question with his next comment. This is coming from the business owner. It's not optional. You need to take cards,
wow,
which is why the
when
idea
did that law get passed?
Which is why if the idea is cost savings, you're looking at a bad business with terrible approach to its customers. Basically, they don't give a crap about you, just your cash. And yes, if a restaurant doesn't take cards, they are stealing money from the state. No paperwork means no sales tax trail. You're giving the state money. Their duty is to deliver it to Albany quarterly. This isn't a joke.
Oh my God.
This guy's serious.
The way he's framing this discussion, let's just go over that and like pick it apart because everything he said is basically backwards.
Yeah. So instead, this is going on. Instead, they steal it. Talking about the restaurants that don't do this.
Keeping your money is stealing. And this is the whole sort of progressive agenda that, you know, I'm generous because I want to give your money to somebody else.
Yeah.
You're not generous. You're just some kind of weird thief.
Yeah. And this, they're stealing the money from the business. Are stealing the money from the state. No, I think that's the other way around.
The thief is the guy pointing the gun.
Yeah.
Okay. And
the
business
state.
Owner isn't pointing the gun. The state is. That's ridiculous.
Wow. This is, I'm glad we chose this because it's just so outrageous. What do you think? Do you own or run a cash-only business? Why do you only take cash and not credit cards? Like, there's lots of good reasons besides being a mafioso. 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest.
They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
This is a national health care alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. So if you're on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. We also have other pain-relieving braces, too, for your shoulder, ankle, or back. You may be eligible to get these items and more at little or no out-of-pocket cost. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to help you, so please call now. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
35% of U.S. credit accounts are facing collection agencies. Of that 35, almost 40% are the result of medical bills. Before uninsured friends or family go in for medical treatment, send them to AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com. No computer tracing, no tracking cookies. They will not go on a list. Privacy matters. Just tell us what you need. Get a quote. Fractions of U.S. prices. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. This is the live Sunday night show. Tonight it's me, Stephanie.
And Brian.
And Mark.
855-450-FREE is our phone number here on Free Talk Live, the Sunday show. That's 855-450-3733. We've been talking about cash-only businesses, but of course you're welcome to bring up anything that's on your mind tonight at, one more time, 855-450-3733.
ExpressCoin.com is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. Whether you're looking to get Bitcoin or Litecoin, Blackcoin, Darkcoin, Dogecoin, whatever other cryptocurrencies they've got there at ExpressCoin.com, they make it fast, safe, easy, inexpensive, and they're a licensed money services business, so you can trust them. Get your cryptocurrencies with a money order, check, wire transfer, or you can make a deposit at a local credit union that has shared branching. just start off at expresscoin.com. Whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, it's expresscoin.com. You can even do it from your smartphone by downloading an app. That's right there at expresscoin.com. You can use coupon code.
Sensing a pattern here.
Yes, indeed. Coupon code FTL to get up to $40 of your cryptocurrency of choice, whether it's Bitcoin or one of the other cryptocurrencies. And you don't have to pay any fee at all. They make it easy for you at expresscoin.com. I recommend them for getting your Bitcoins. Expresscoin.com, coupon code FTL.
All right, let's go to the phones and talk to John in Iowa, listening on, what is it, KBUR 1490. Hi, John. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hi. I know some people that have cash-only businesses. And
are they mafiosos?
Have their own. No. They own their own ATMs.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't have cash with you. Go ahead and use my ATM. They get their $3 upcharge on the ATM. Goes in their pocket instead of paying the credit card company the other way.
Yeah. It makes a lot of sense.
Well, I would say if you're a restaurant, you have to have really compelling food or service or ambiance or something to get people to come back for this. Because I would agree that this is a form of customer service that I like to see at restaurants. There's
you
no doubt about
the
it.
The ability to pay with a credit card?
Yeah, the ability to pay with a credit card.
Oh, yeah. I think if you're a business, it kind of makes sense to accept payment in whatever way is most convenient for your customers. So by not accepting credit cards, you know, they might be turning away some customers, and they have to be good enough to be able to be that picky, right?
Yeah, but there's restaurants that give you a discount for paying with cash too.
Mm.
Yeah, a lot
Doctor's
of businesses will do that
too. Have you ever heard that cash only discount? Yeah.
They got them here.
Yeah. Thanks, John, for the call tonight. I appreciate your input.
Yeah, I don't know. I think that there's like a certain attitude towards cash, though, that I don't like what it's backed by. It's backed by violence, right? I mean, you know,
but it's
because
still dollars.
Yeah, it's the U.S. government says this is money, so it's money. I don't like that. But the anonymity of cash, not just the anonymity, but
you
the overall, the just the total control you really have over cash, other than, of course, where its value comes from, blows away any other currency out there, bar none.
Indeed.
Okay, and
you
so
no
I
one can stop you from handing a dollar bill to someone. They can stop you from cashing a check. Or,
yeah, I don't appreciate that this disrespect for cash. I mean, I think it's a very for what it
cash
is in the system we have. It is a good thing.
It's been criminalized.
Yeah.
I mean, it's I could say a lot about this, but we've got phone calls, so let's go to Mark in New York. Hey, Mark, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Yeah, I love listening to you guys.
Thank you.
So
not boring and gay?
really quick, I went to one of the big box stores. Occasionally, I go in now with my new wife, but no matter if it's $10 or $500, I pull cash out. So one day, this woman, they must have had something with someone overseeing everything because they picked me out of the crowd. She said, would you like to fill out a survey? So I said, okay. I went to the computer. Then they started asking me too many personal questions. I said, oh, I know why you're doing this, because I did not use a credit card. I said, you know what, I just can't. I just walked away from the computer. She says, oh, don't you want to finish? We'll give you some gift. I said, no, I know what you're doing. I didn't use a credit card, so you can't track my purchases and who I am.
Yeah.
Because I use cash. And what I'm noticing a lot now, a lot of places, a lot of delis that I go to here in New York, they'll say we can't accept, especially the Dunkin' Donuts, we can't accept over a $20 bill. Sometimes I'll pull out a 50 or a C note. I say, look, this is all I got. You take it or leave it. You know, so that's steadily trying to criminalize using cash. I notice it. And I also went to a Chase Bank. And believe me, I'm giving you all these corporations that I'm trying to get out of.
It's hard to get away from them. They're just everywhere.
But you know what? If cash didn't exist, you could never get away from them. I mean, that's
it's
the thing.
True.
If everything was credit cards, you'd be screwed.
Yeah. So, sorry. Absolutely. Go ahead. What happened at the Chase Bank?
Well, they had the rule up that you had to have you couldn't deposit a certain amount over $50,000 unless you were in someone else, like for a small business, or you couldn't do it for someone else. It had to go into your account.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, oh, I know. Now you're trying to regulate because this is part of the bail-in. And she says, no, we just have to have more information on people because of drug dealing. I said, drug dealing? I said, you banks are the biggest drug dealers out there.
It's true. HSBC. You know,
right.
They had that
she
big.
She looked at me and she said, "Oh, Mark, you know, come." I said, "No, it's the truth." I said, "When are you going to go over to force the laundromats, which is a quarters? Oh, we won't do that because there's too much of a big stink. Because there are some laundromats, one in Connecticut in particular, you have to purchase a card to use a laundromat. And it's not like a quarter for a certain amount of time or a dollar for it. It's actually like $1.89, a dollar. So if you use the card, you're actually giving them more money than you need for your dryer or your washer.
Unbelievable.
It is. It's really just a way to control and to steal from the people. That's why I don't mean to keep droning on here, but my employer wants me. They want to stop. And, of course, J.P. Morgan Chase issues all our checks. Mm-hmm. They want us to go direct deposit. I
right.
said, no, I want a check, and I want a cash. And where I do with my cash is none of your business. You know?
Yeah, indeed, Mark. I'm with you.
Sometimes they say, you know, you got to stop pulling cash because you're going to get robbed. And I simply say, when? You know,
it seems like you're more likely to get robbed by the government.
Yeah, you're getting robbed by the percentages of credit cards.
Thank you for calling in. I'm totally with them there.
Yeah, I agree. I think there might be a war on cash.
I think there is a war on cash.
Or at least a war on the attitude of cash.
Yeah. There was one time when I tried to pay a bill with cash at a Walmart by sending a MoneyGram or something like that, and they wanted me to fill out a form with my social security number and occupation.
Mm.
It's like, there's nothing good that could possibly come of that. So I said, all right, well, I'm not going to be paying this bill with cash then. Let's talk to Bill in Pennsylvania. Hey, Bill, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hello, fellow Americans. How are you doing?
I don't know if I'd consider myself an American.
No, I was listening to basically how they were talking about, you know, the government taking advantage and that kind of thing. And I know that we're not probably the only state that deals with what they call real estate school property tax that only homeowners pay.
And you're in Pennsylvania?
Yeah, correct.
Mm-hmm.
And the issue that I had, I just recently had my tax assessment appeal back on the end of September. And I went back at least 4 years because I've only been a resident since 4 years, being an honorable Navy veteran as well. I addressed the issue that how is it possible that any federal, state, or county government, and the county government basically falls in the locality, a county government can turn around and say what your house is worth by their opinion and tax you on an opinion. And if they do that, if they are taxing your house based on their opinion, shows ownership that they own that piece of property and you're being treated as a tenant in your own
Indeed
home.
Indeed they do, Bill. Thanks for the call tonight. Yeah, laws are just opinions backed by guns, aren't they?
Yeah, and if you have to pay...
$855-450 free here on Free Talk Live.
If you have to pay annually to live in a place, it's not yours.
Yeah, you're
renting. That's rent.
$855-450 free, Free Talk Live.
I will never forget the day my son Jeremy told me he hated me and slammed the door in my face. I'm behavioral therapist Janet Lehman. Behavior problems can turn the child you love and your life into a nightmare. That's why my husband James and I created the Total Transformation, the step-by-step program that shows you how to fix the worst behavior problems and get your child to respect and listen to you again. No matter what the behavior, defiance, backtalk, angry outbursts, disrespect, we can help you stop it. Now you can get the Total Transformation for free. All you need to do is get the program and let us know how it works for you. You can keep it forever for free.
Limited number of free programs available. Call now 1-888-912-1595. 1-888-912-1595. That's 1-888-912-1595. 1-888-912-1595.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. This is the live Sunday night show. Tonight, it's me, Stephanie.
And Brian.
And Mark.
855-450-FREE. Those are the Pro XPN toll-free call-in lines here on Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. We're talking about the war on cash, but you can bring up anything that's on your mind. Also call on Skype at lrn.fm.
At bitcoinbountyhunter.com, there are bounties available right now. One's worth 38 bitcoins, which is like more than $10,000. You can use your investigative skills and collect the bounty. You can place your own bounty, or you can add to the ones that are there. The authorities aren't going to be solving these cases. They're going to be done by people like you, people that profit from their work and skill. Go check it out. It's bitcoinbountyhunter.com. I'd love to see one of our listeners get one of these bounties. It's bitcoinbountyhunter.com.
Very cool. All right, let's go back to the phones. We've got calls. Mark is listening in Ocean City, New Jersey. Hey, Mark, you're on Free Talk Live.
How you doing?
Doing great tonight. What's on your mind?
Oh, I don't know. This topic's getting pretty gay and boring.
Yeah?
Doesn't surprise me.
Well, listen, here's, you know what's funny about that guy? He, you know, I listen to talk radio all day. I drive a cab. You know, it's funny. You're so boring and whatever else, but you know what he did? He listened. He knew the number.
Indeed.
He called and sat through the screening, and he waited and to do all that, but he never listens, and he listens to
the podcast. Yeah, maybe he was trying to do me a favor.
It's surprising how many people are willing to do that, isn't it?
Yeah. He's trying to do me a favor. Here I am wasting my life at something I'm terrible at, and he's trying he's spent his valuable time letting me know so that I can go on and do something more productive.
Yep. And you know what the best part is? He's still listening.
We're talking about him.
Anyway, did you have something you want to say about cash only businesses?
No, I don't. I actually want to bring something else up.
Oh, please.
I don't understand what is the big deal about asking people to produce simple ID to vote? Why, like, what is the big deal? Like, why it's like they, you know, it's just we're discriminating the minorities by asking them to have ID. But why can't they just have ID? What's the big, like, why can't you just have ID and it should be necessary to vote? Period. I mean, they go to the check cashing place and cash checks with, they have to have ID, but when it comes time to vote, you know, it's like, oh, we don't have any ID. You know, and it's just, I don't understand what's the big crime asking them to have ID? It becomes,
well, there are, actually, there's states that, black participation in voting has increased. And these are states with some of the most restrictive voting rules out there. So I think that the claims that somehow voter identification is racist is spurious. Now, I do think that there's certainly some people out there that don't have ID. You know, if you're old enough, you're not driving anymore, maybe you don't need one. I suppose if you're like on the street or something like that, you don't need an ID or whatever. But it doesn't take too many life skills to go down to the DMV or whatever, and usually somebody
so
who doesn't have an ID.
You're in favor of voter ID stuff?
I'm in favor that if somebody's going to make votes that make a decision upon my life, that they have enough life skills to simply get a government ID. That's all I'm asking for.
I will take a devil's advocate position, because I think voting is a problem in general.
I'm with you. Democracy,
okay. It's an issue.
Well,
but let me finish what I'm saying. But if you have an ID in order to vote, like, isn't there some concern that you might lose that protection of the secret ballot, the anonymous ballot, you know, that's not tied to who you are? And then, because if it is tied to who you are in any way, then there's the chance that you could be punished or persecuted or intimidated based on how you voted, right?
Well, I think it's pretty important. Secret ballot is like the most powerful aspect of democracy at the end of the day, is the secret ballot. But I think, honestly, like, the ID system is really quite a failure in the fact that we have so many how many voters that were positively identified in 2000 were dead? Hundreds of thousands, because it was voter fraud.
Yeah.
So I think there's a lot of bigger issues to really address than ID, because ID is actually getting used for voter fraud, I think, more than it is if not having it would cause.
Oh, so you're saying the fraud was made possible because...
The fraud is because of ID.
Because of ID.
I think the numbers might stack up, but I could be wrong about that.
Mark?
I don't know. It just turns into a political... It's all just political.
Sure, sure it does. You know, oh, yeah, man.
Sure, there's problems all the way around.
Yeah, it's a shame, and it's a shame that they use the minority and the fact that the ID, and they just use them. It's a shame. Like, it's,
yeah, these politicians are using whole populations for their own ends and not for the good of the populations. You're absolutely right.
Indeed. Yeah. And, Mark, thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate your thoughts and bringing that subject up. There's quite a controversy over this in New Hampshire, actually.
Oh, yeah.
You know, because we're the first primary. Not that I don't think voting makes much of a difference anyway. There's
but
really not.
But if you bus in enough people during a primary, you can really make a difference. And since New Hampshire's first in the nation, I think we've got a lot more of it.
It takes a lot of effort to make a dime's worth of difference in the political system. I mean,
that much is true. Yeah. But there are plenty of instances where, you know, people, I only know of the Republicans getting the Democrats because that's sort of the groups I travel with, but I'm sure there's the Democrats getting the Republicans on this one, too. I've seen evidence, and the state's attorney's office just sweeps it under the rug. And then the problem, I mean, they just don't want to go after it. It's misdemeanors. It's not worth it to them. And then when you see the, people reporting on this, they say it's not a problem. It's like 88 times out of 850,000 votes cast in whatever period of time. You know, I can see why when you look at the numbers, it doesn't look like that big of a deal. But when you don't have AGs going after people, you know, how many votes have been cast spuriously that didn't get counted? I don't know.
It's hard to have a system where everybody gets one vote, but you don't know who voted for what.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Sure.
Anyway, let's go back to the phones. Talk to Chris in Connecticut. Hey, Chris, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, good evening, guys. And he misspoke before when talking about the only mafia organization.
Chris, your audio is breaking up a little bit.
Yeah, I'm afraid there's some problem with the cell phone or Skype or whatever it is.
Try again?
How about now? Yes, no, maybe?
Yeah, now it's good. Go ahead.
All right. Hey, before Brian had said that credit card companies were the only mafias left, he misspoke, and I just wish to correct that for the listeners.
Sure.
Obviously, all government organizations, state, local, and federal, are racketeering organizations by the very definition of the word.
How could we forget?
Yeah, I agree.
Services. Yeah.
Thank you. They'll come and break your legs figuratively if you set up an unlicensed hot dog stand. So they're clearly mafia rackets purporting to be legitimate. and they're evil, and we hate them. And I'll let you guys go.
Yeah, indeed. Thanks for the call, Chris.
I absolutely stand corrected on that. Fortunately, I can stand without getting my legs broken by these groups.
On Free Talk Live, we can admit when we...
Yeah, that's right.
We can admit that we're fallible, right?
Yeah.
Luckily, we have listeners like that. All right, let's talk to Carl, listening in New Jersey. Hey, Carl, you're on Free Talk Live.
Thanks for taking my call. What I was going to say is you should look at the signs because maybe that restaurant won't take the credit card you carry.
Mark, he's talking to you. You said you don't, earlier, Mark, you said you don't look at the signs on restaurants.
Generally, yeah. I mean, I get it. But if you carry a MasterCard or a Visa, the chances are good that they're going to take it, right?
Yeah, but see, I carry Discover and they all don't take that.
Yeah, same with American Express.
The fees are higher on both of those, and that's the reason.
Yeah. Mm.
Okay. Now, I carry that new card, the card that our president carries, and none of them take that.
Which one is that?
China Express Platinum. No credit limit.
Well, I don't get it.
We're running off of China's credit, pretty much. Or the U.S. is running off of China's credit. Yeah.
Thank you for the call, Carl. Appreciate it. Yeah, indeed. Let's talk to Dana in Michigan. Hey, Dana, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi to everybody. What was it that Brian said about, I'm sorry, I want to make sure I didn't misunderstand, about using deceased people for fraud?
Yeah, this was a big problem in Florida in particular during the Bush-Gore election.
Dead people rose from the dead.
That they were using dead people as of counting them as voters.
Hold the line, Dana, if you've got more. I want to hear more of what you have to say. This is Free Talk Live. If you have something you want to bring up, 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. How can a dead person vote? Interesting, huh? More coming up. This is the Sunday Show.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Hey guys, if you're into fantasy football, you've got to check out FanDuel.com. At FanDuel, you play in one-week fantasy football leagues for real money with immediate cash payouts. You only play when you want, and you can change your team any week. FanDuel is paying out over $10 million every week this season. And right now, FanDuel is giving you up to $200 free. That's right, for every dollar you deposit, FanDuel will match it up to $200. Just go to FanDuel.com, click the microphone in the upper right corner, and enter code FOOTBALL70. FANDUEL.com, code FOOTBALL, the number 70.
At 30dayfoodsupply.com, you can now purchase a one-of-a-kind product not available anywhere else, a meatless burger dry mix in four delicious flavors. With our new Oregon Trail Foods vegan burgers, all you do is add water and fry. They need no refrigeration. They're packaged in Mylar bags with an oxygen absorber for a long shelf life. They're non-GMO. They're gluten, soy, nut, and chemical-free, but they're loaded with flavor and a good source of carbs and protein, yet low in sodium. Flavors include Italian, spicy Mexican, six vegetable, and black bean olive. Go to 30dayfoodsupply.com or call 541-229-0010 and order today. Eat them every day, take them camping, or save them for an emergency. Check them out at 30dayfoodsupply.com and click on the vegan burger icon. That's 30dayfoodsupply.com, where all of our products are produced in Oregon by Oregon Trail Foods. 30dayfoodsupply.com.
Keenvention is coming up October 31st through November 2nd. Get your tickets now at keenvention.info. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, attend social events like the costume party. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, James Robin Hood Cleveland, Rich Paul, and Free State Project President Carla Garrick will be keynoting. And we'll have all kinds of panels, including the new Cop Block panel and the new Movers panel hosted by the outlaw Josie Wales. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. Only 100 tickets are available in advance, so lock yours in now for just $60 or with Bitcoin.
Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at lrn.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at lrn.fm. That's lrn.fm.
Khalid lives in Gaza. He makes his living as a taxi driver. The engine in his old beater blew up. Now, he makes good money driving people in his cab, but he couldn't afford the $1,300 for a new engine. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the engine, and he's back on the road. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. This is the Sunday Night Show. It's me, Stephanie, here.
And Brian.
And Mark.
This is a show where you can call and bring up anything that's on your mind, from dead people voting to ancient aliens. You can even call us boring and gay if you want to. This is Free Talk Live. And our number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can also call us on Skype at lrn.fm. And those phone lines, of course, are sponsored by our favorite VPN provider, ProXPN. Let's go right back to the phones, where Dana in Michigan is on the line. Now, Dana, we were just talking to you in the last segment about something that had come up earlier on the show related to voter fraud, where in Florida, I guess, was that the Bush-Gore election, the very contested one, where there were people that were supposed to have voted, but those people were actually deceased at the time of the election, so how could they have voted?
Right, but this happens all over the place, not just in Florida.
Yeah, I've heard of it.
Yeah,
right. It happened in Kennedy did it, and that was before everything was so electronic.
Right.
There was no internet. But here's the thing. There's this. I have a couple things I want to say to you guys. One, ever since 9/11, you cannot enter a federal building without showing a valid picture ID. So if you don't drive, you can still get a state ID, but it has to have a picture and your signature on it. There's that. Then there's this gentleman, I just happened to be listening, I was channel surfing, and this gentleman named Mark Simone was filling in for Sean Hannity, and he was going to be on Rachel Maddow's show, and there were going to be all these anti-voter ID saying it's racist. Everything is racist if you don't agree with them. Or
it's a great way to shut down conversation, now. Right? Just call something racist.
Exactly. Yeah.
Right?
I think both of you are sexist.
Or if they can't, if it doesn't involve a race, if they're the same race as you, they shut you down by making you look crazy. So anyway, they were questioning this Mark Simone because he was reporting this when he filled in this particular. It was like a couple months ago. I just happened to hear this on the radio. Mm-hmm. And he said they were talking about voter ID. And he says, well, I had a show when I entered your building at NBC Studios. Then I had a show at this point and this point and this point. He had to show it plus fill out forms before. And this is a well-known radio personality. Mark Simone, I think he has his own radio show, and just to get on Rachel Maddow's show, as soon as he said that, the entire panel changed the subject. It was so awkward. It's the kind of awkward where you're in your living room alone, and there's no one to discuss it with, and yet you feel this intense pain. It was so uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. If people are dead, when they die, you have to report to certain agencies, you know, to different agencies. People can't be just dead and buried. And so there's all these, you know, there's different paperwork you have to fill out. So that should immediately, because driver's licenses are tied to names in other states, and everything's tied into the internet and everything's tied into the federal government, that should be the way they can connect them and shut down those, you know, so they're not just using those names off the voter rolls. If you have to walk in, you know what, and even old people, let me say a few things. Poor people, whether they're black or Hispanic or white, have to have ID to get any of the Department of Human Services, any food stamps, any anything. They have to have ID if you're elderly, to open a bank account, if you have direct deposit for Social Security.
Yep.
So don't sit there and tell me, oh, they're disenfranchised. That's bull. That's what they do. I will give them this. They're cunning. But cunning smart is not a good smart, and it's not healthy for the rest of us. That's what they're using. They're using, we're trying to disenfranchise. No, what they're trying to do is continually pick those dead rolls.
What do you think the criteria for somebody to be able to vote should be?
Oh, God. Honestly? I think they should have to take some kind of test. And quite frankly,
what would be on the test?
Stephanie, I don't know, but I'm just saying that kind of sort of facetiously, because listen, I'm going to tell you something, and Stephanie, don't be offended. Do you know white women overwhelmingly over and over and over in every election vote for a person based on their looks, a man based on their looks?
I've heard people say it.
I've heard that, yeah.
I've
heard people just pick the name that looks most convincing, too.
I had this gal that I was out for drinks with this with some friends, and this gal said, I'm voting for George Bush. He's just so good-looking. And I'm like, well, A, what?
As though that
and
matters,
B,
yeah.
What?
But really, what other skills do these people have?
I'm not offended by that, Dana, because I don't participate in the political process. You know, it's just, okay. I agree with you. It's so silly.
Something.
Yep.
I want to tell you guys what happened. If people don't believe this, because so many of the few left-wing talk shows there are, because conservative radio is more right, but the few that are and are spouting this nonsense, let me give you a fact, and everyone can run to their little computers on the left, all the good little progressives and communists and socialists, and check this out. In Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and then I believe it's Harrison County. I don't know if Harrison County is in Philadelphia or it's over in Ohio. They polled nonpartisan pollers, polled the polls during the 2012 Obama. And that this one very important county in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, likewise, this very important county in Ohio, overwhelmingly said they had pulled the little knob for Romney. And get this, 100% in the Ohio county was for Obama, and 105 in Philadelphia. Could someone please explain that to me?
That sounds like a mistake.
Sounds like a landslide.
Yeah, thank you, Dana, for the call tonight.
Broken system. It's a broken system.
It is. Yeah, that's why I guess I don't get too upset about voter fraud, because I don't know that it's very possible to make much meaningful change inside the political system anyway. So
In the internet age, the interconnected age hasn't solved anything. I mean, in 2006 in New York, there were still like 77,000 dead people on the voter rolls.
Yeah.
And I think they said something around 3,000 of that were used.
You might have to report to various government agencies when someone dies, but that doesn't mean they update their records.
No, they don't. They're terrible at this. In Florida, speaking of Florida, like in 2012, there was 53,000 dead people still on the voter rolls. I mean, like the numbers, they don't stop. And this is up to today. Where is government? They should be updating this. But it really, the story can be told in the voting system itself, because the voting system that we have, that the United States has, is based upon a time of horse and buggy. And it is designed to resolve that speed of travel, that lack of speed of travel. And it has never been updated. You know,
I think it did get updated at one. The president going in on January 12th is new, like a century new or something like that.
Okay, so the time frame that's been updated, but I mean, by and large, the system is like the Electoral College. That whole purpose of that system is to handle the fact that look, the message isn't going to get to you for a few days.
But I don't trust these electronic voting machines.
I don't either.
The only thing I trust. Wasn't there a story that came out pretty recently where there was one of the machines, like somebody looked at the code on the machine and it was programmed to actually be biased toward Republicans, like to give more votes to the Republicans.
I've heard that. I've heard that they can be hacked remotely. I've heard all kinds of stuff and none of it makes me very comfortable with it.
Doesn't matter who votes, matters who count the votes. It, right?
Indeed. Now, on a town level, in my town, you can show up when they count the votes at, 7:05, and they do a recount right there, so there's no real argument. Everything's written in pencil on a piece of paper. There's people in the room all day long with the box. It seems very unlikely that those things are rigged. But as the power structure gets bigger and bigger, and as the votes get taken off to someplace,
there's more at stake.
Well, just because the count is the way it is in my town, once it gets taken to Concord, for instance, to get counted for the primary or something like that. So I believe my select people, or selectmen is what they're called here, whether they're men or women. My selectmen are my selectmen. But I don't really believe anything beyond that. Once the votes get taken in a box someplace else, I don't trust it anymore. The electronic voting machines, I don't trust those either. And that's really the problem. You don't think that the people in Washington, D.C., I mean, politicians synonymous with a cheater, you don't think they'd be willing to cheat if they could?
Of course, especially when there's that much power at stake.
Yeah,
I don't trust the whole voting process. How about that?
Yeah,
it's not just who counts the votes or whatever. I don't trust the whole system. It's rotten to the core.
Yeah, I mean, I don't believe in the political system at all, but I can say if I did, the last thing I'd want is for the seat of power to be so far away. You have to have it as close as possible, and you have to deal with how that works because it's far better than the problems that Americans have now with getting, such crazy responses from around the world towards America. Look, they're not hating Americans. They are hating what the American foreign policy is, and it is out of Americans' control.
Yeah, absolutely. 855-450-3733 is the number here on Free Talk Live. Talk to us about voter fraud, about cash-only businesses, or anything else that's on your mind. 855-450-FREE. This is Free Talk Live. More coming up on the Sunday show.
Talk radio generally, and Free Talk Live specifically, are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Did you know that Free Aid is a mutual aid, educational, and networking organization? At Free Aid, we support volunteers who provide first aid. We do outreach to the public about health and safety, and we bring together medically skilled freedom lovers. Free Aid is made possible by your generous support. Donors can receive great gifts like first aid kits, t-shirts, silver dime cards, and hoodies. The Free Aid Silver Dime Card Project is sponsored in part by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage, Freedom's Phoenix, and Don't Tread on Meme. Visit fr33aid.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Canaan, the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, October 12th, 2014. Silver is trading at $17.41 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,224 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $360. Antiwar.com reports losses continue to mount in the Kurdish town of Kobani along the border between Syria and Turkey, and while the YPG militia says they've succeeded in defending the town's central square, the Islamic State takeover continues to seem inevitable. Kurdish militia officials pushed for a further escalation of U.S. airstrikes against the Islamic State and the surrounding area, though with the fighting now taking place street to street inside the town itself, it's hard to imagine the U.S. being able to target the fighters without leveling neighborhoods. The Islamic State has been pushing against Kobani on and off for months now, and in the offensive over the last several weeks has seized more than 350 villages in the surrounding area. The loss of Kobani effectively means the end of a significant independent Kurdish presence in Aleppo. It could also be the beginning of the end for an independent Syrian Kurdistan as the remnants fall back into the northeastern corner of the nation and refugees continue to pour into Turkey. Though they're all ethnically Kurdish, the leadership in Iraqi and Syrian Kurdistan are starkly different, with the Iraqi Kurdish government built around a handful of powerful families, and the Syrian Kurdish territory run mostly by political parties with their roots in Turkey. FPP Radio News is brought to you by The Doublespeak Dictionary. The Doublespeak Dictionary by Leslie Starr O'Hara satirizes the marked difference between the ideal of we the people and the reality of we the elite, while offering an insightful glimpse into the clockworks of the totalitarian mind. Ever irreverent but never irrelevant, the Doublespeak Dictionary serves as a subversive and humorous but timely reminder that the emperor has no clothes. The Doublespeak Dictionary is available from Amazon.com and all major bookstores. Wired reports lawyers for Ross Ulbricht have spent the last 2 months shifting the focus from their client, charged with creating the billion-dollar drug market, Silk Road, and putting it onto the potential illegality of the FBI's investigation. In a 38-page ruling on Friday, Judge Catherine Forrest dismissed the defense's motion to suppress evidence that hinged on the argument that law enforcement had violated Ulbricht's Fourth Amendment right to privacy from an unreasonable search. Just last week, Ulbricht's lawyers went so far as to contend that the FBI had illegally hacked a Silk Road server in Iceland without a warrant to determine the location. But the judge's rejection of that argument comes down to what may be seen as a fateful technicality. She argues that even if the FBI did hack the Silk Road server, Ulbricht had not sufficiently demonstrated that the server belonged to him and thus can't claim that his privacy rights were violated by its search. She wrote, "Defendant has brought what he must certainly understand is a fatally deficient motion to suppress evidence. He has failed to take the one step he needed to allow the court to consider his claim regarding the investigation. He has failed to submit anything establishing that he has a personal privacy interest in the Icelandic server or any of the other items imaged and or searched and or seized." That argument may seem like a catch-22. If Ulbricht were to claim ownership of that server, he would seem to incriminate himself, but Forrest writes that Ulbricht could have nonetheless claimed the server in a pretrial statement that could not be used against him as evidence. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Reuters reports thousands of protesters marched through St. Louis on Saturday as part of a weekend of demonstrations against police violence organized after the fatal shooting of an unarmed teenager by a police officer over the summer. After a peaceful half-mile march through downtown, protesters rallied at Kiner Plaza. Organizers included Hands Up United, an activist group that emerged after the August 9th shooting of 18-year-old Michael Brown in suburban Ferguson, Missouri. Civil rights organizations and protest groups have invited people from around the country to join vigils and marches in the St. Louis area from Friday to Monday. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
This is the Onion Week in Review. A report by Stanford University researchers released Thursday found that Americans spend 90% of their waking hours staring at glowing rectangles. Researchers identified more than 30 varieties of iridescent rectangles, ranging from personal and work rectangles to rectangles that heat food and those that can fit right in one's pocket.
From the moment Americans wake up, they are captivated by these bright, pulsing rectangles. In fact, if you look at the data, it's hard to find a single minute when the public isn't captivated by these. Excuse me. I'm sorry, where were we?
In local news, a runover squirrel is remembered as frantic and indecisive. And in other news, a trail of rose petals leads a wife to a sink full of dishes. Prince Fielder reports to spring training exactly the right amount overweight, and a local yard sale reeks of divorce. If you don't hear the sound of my voice the same time next week, alert my family and then visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
Free Talk Live. This is hour number three of tonight's program. Free Talk Live is a show where you can call and bring up anything that's on your mind. From the state trooper, which we were talking about earlier, who preached to a woman during a pullover, to the controversial billboard that Pornhub was forced to take down, to ancient aliens. You can bring up anything else that's on your mind, too. Our number here on Free Talk Live, the Pro-XPN toll-free call-in number, is 855-450-3733. That's 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. Here on Free Talk Live. Or if you want to call us on Skype, there's always the option to do that. Our Skype ID is lrn.fm. Now, in the last segment, we were actually talking about, well, maybe it wasn't the last segment. It was a couple segments ago. In the last hour of the show, we were talking about restaurants that only accept cash. And are they all just dirty, mafioso, money laundering drug fronts? Or is there legit reason that a restaurant might only want to accept cash? Brian, do you got more for us?
Yeah, well, just to kind of recap what this is from Gothamist, and so it's from it's about New York City in particular, but I think it has an overarching message, frankly. And we got a lot of calls and people saying that, you know, yeah, they're experiencing the same and they think it's ridiculous to call it that. But Gothamist talked to restaurant owners, business owners in New York City to get their opinion. And I just want to reiterate what that opinion is. And that is, it's not optional. You need to take cards, which is why, if the idea is cost savings, you're looking at a business with a terrible approach to its customers. Basically, they don't give a crap about you, just your cash. And this is the worst part. And yes, if a restaurant doesn't take cards, they are stealing money from the state. Okay.
Now, this guy just wants to drive his competition out of business. I think he's jealous. He probably wishes he could just take
cash. He says it's unethical. As it goes on, he says it's unethical.
Unethical.
He says cash only is an unethical business practice.
You know,
this is a guy that owns multiple businesses in New York City, and I will give him credit. It is very tough to run one business alone, but multiple businesses in New York City, that is a feat.
Yeah, I mean, so it may make the accounting a little more difficult if you only take cash, right? Versus if you have a digital trail of everything. But it is optional. He said it's not optional. It is completely optional.
Yeah.
And in fact, customers will reward the businesses that make it easiest for them to pay and that serve them in the best way. And so if they're keeping a restaurant or a cafe afloat that only accepts cash, that must be a market signal that, hey, that business is doing something right and that's okay. And they don't have to take credit cards.
Sure. And to go on, this is Gothamist talking now, not that business owner, but a place that doesn't take cards is bad. But a place that doesn't take cards and has an ATM right outside, that's just straight up evil. It's like, thanks for patronizing our establishment. Let me kick you in the crotch on the way out. Worse yet Ooh. Is the popular cash only place with the ATM, like Peter, or they name off some restaurants, that makes you feel like the owner is just rubbing it in your face. It's with the ATM inside, I guess.
Yeah, and I mean, I don't particularly like that. I don't like that $3 that I have to pay to get money out of an ATM. There's no doubt about it. Mm-hmm. But I mean, either your business can demand this, and I mean, this is, it's a hurdle, right? Like, you know, prices are a hurdle. The payment systems are a hurdle. You know, there's all kinds of things that are hurdles to doing business. If you're just gonna take cash, it's a hurdle. But if people are willing to come and fill your booths, I don't see any reason why you should take cards and give a cut to the banks.
Exactly.
Yeah.
We do have a phone call on the line. Let's talk to Prem listening in Nebraska. Hey, Prem, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, it's nice to hear different topics you choose. I like most of them. Good of you.
Thank you.
Taking cash, there seems to be a kind of a problem with many people. But if you see most of the gas stations for diesel, they give you kind of a discount. So giving discount, it need not necessarily be a kind of an evil. For example, let's take in a gas station, they say, let's say 10,000 gallons of gas they fill every day.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say $3 per a gallon, that comes to how much? $30,000.
Right.
And imagine 3 days accumulation by the credit card company.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's big money.
$100,000.
Yeah, you know, the gas company or the gas station business is a great example, because when the gas prices started to really skyrocket in the United States, this is what, 2005, when it started going above $3 or whatever, going above $2, this was commonplace for gas stations to actually give you the discount, essentially take off the fee that goes to the credit cards if you paid in cash. And the reason they did that is because they knew that Americans were ticked. That they were paying so much in...
They've got pretty thin margins, too.
Oh, so very thin margins. So a 3%
difference can make an actual pretty big
Absolutely.
Impact.
So, I mean, who's going to say these gas stations were evil? No, they really cared about the customer. They wanted cash.
Well, they must just be mafioso money laundering drug dealers if they're taking cash. The gas is all just a front. Thank you, Prem, for the call tonight. I appreciate your thoughts.
Yeah, it's true.
By the way, have you ever... I think this has come up on the program before, but... Have you ever tried to pay for a hotel with cash? Like, they pretty much always want a credit card for incidental charges or deposit or whatever.
Rental cars and hotels can be very difficult to do business in cash.
Yeah. I mean, not everybody has credit cards. There are lots of situations where, you know, perhaps...
I've wanted to get rid of them, but, you know, you almost have to have them to operate. I do some traveling for Free Talk Live. I've got to go to conventions and things like that. And how am I going to have a hotel room? How am I going to get a rental car? Mm-hmm. How am I going to pay for my airplane tickets?
Well, you can get a debit card if you don't have credit or you have bad credit or whatever, but then you have to actually have the money to back it up. It's almost like it becomes like a secured credit card.
Yeah, even that, though, can be a problem, because you'll have to, like, I think if you want to rent a car, you have to have at least $500 on that debit card, even if you're only going to spend, like, $100.
Yeah.
And a debit card opens you to dangers. So, I mean, if your credit card gets swiped or whatever...
you're not liable.
You're liable for $50.
Yeah.
If your debit card gets swiped and you've got $500 in there, your $500 is gone.
Absolutely.
Your credit card gives you the ability to dispute charges. And your debit card really doesn't.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a variety of reasons why debit cards are a poor solution for that.
True.
Yeah, you know, one time I remember I checked into a hotel and they basically wanted to pre-authorize like about $700 worth of charges on my credit card for the stay, because they wanted like, I don't know, $200 a day, $150 a day, something like that. And I didn't have room on the credit card that I first gave them. And they looked at me like I was some kind of deviant because I didn't have $700 worth of free credit on the credit cards. I'd keep giving them cards until I found one that worked, right?
Yeah. And, you know, it's a real problem, because actually credit cards, and in fact Apple Pay and some of these other payment solutions that have come out that are based upon your mobile device, really are trying to solve the fact that credit cards are not secure. They are a terribly insecure way of transacting money. I mean, they're bad at it. And one of the reasons that, because people are saying, it's like, why would these credit card companies work with Apple Pay, which is Apple's literal integration of a payment system with their iPhones? Why would they work with them? It's like they're going to lose out on fees. There's going to be all this stuff. It doesn't seem to make a big deal because the credit card companies are losing so much money on credit card theft and on, you know, theft that has anything to do with that, where people just have all your numbers and they're using it online. They get your CV2 number and it's over.
Indeed.
Yeah. And so that's really the key thing here is that it is a terrible way of securing your money as to where cash, I think, is really, I mean, you could secure that a lot easier. You can't put a credit card in your belt.
Yeah, nobody can take your cash unless they physically take it from you. So that's a barrier. Whereas with cyber crime or whatever, you know, credit card number generators, you could just hit on a credit card number that works. Most of the time, the numbers are based on some kind of code. It's not actually like a 16-digit number. Like some of the numbers are always the same or they're based on your social security number. So someone can figure it out relatively easily. And then that's when you get into trouble.
Yeah,
but they know that you're not going to be liable for it, that the credit card company is going to pay. So they don't feel bad about using it to buy stuff for themselves.
Sure, but it's interesting how many people, and this is just so true for so many things, how ease of use is more important than security or anonymity.
Oh, ain't that the truth? 855-450-FREE here on Free Talk Live. Have you had a credit card stolen? How did it affect your life? 855-450-FREE.
If Americans continue their reckless disregard of the U.S. Constitution, our freedoms and way of life may not continue. Original Intent, Spoiler, and Moulin Labbé is a three-movie special that explains what we can do. From the director of Fiat Empire, this trio of movies features Ron Paul, Pat Buchanan, Edwin Vieira, and many others. On sale now at moviepubs.net. This is a mini library you don't want to be without.
Talk radio generally, and Free Talk Live specifically, are a really inexpensive way to reach customers. All advertising is about return on investment. If you keep your investment low, you have a better chance of seeing a proper return. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations and the internet, reaching hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, mark@freetalklive.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Over 60% of employers are now checking online amateur pornography of potential job candidates. Is it fair to base hiring decisions on an applicant's online porn?
Now, this is not fair at all. For instance, if there's a red tube video of my girlfriend slapping me and choking me and riding me, that shouldn't be an indication I'm going to lack leadership in a work situation.
Yeah, but Duncan, it's going to be hard to convince an employer who's masturbating to that video otherwise.
Exactly. My potential employer might see all those videos of my husband tying me up and having his way with me, and then they're going to think that I'm not going to be assertive enough for the job.
I mean, if you don't want to jeopardize the content of your porn, you can always shoot from the eyes down.
Oh, but that's not the same if you cover the eyes. That's where the innocence is.
So am I supposed to leave an orgy just because someone shows up with a camera?
No one's saying you should leave an orgy.
No, right.
No, it's more complicated.
So now if I go to a party, I wear something like this in case that situation comes up again.
I like that. I actually shoot my porn in a sepia tone and make it look old-timey, so if people see it, they'll think it's my grandfather and not.
Okay.
This is the Onion News Network.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. This is the live Sunday night edition. Yes, we are live. In fact, we're in the third hour of tonight's program. But if you missed a moment of the show, never fear. It's all there for you for free online. You can go to archives.freetalklive.com and get archives of Free Talk Live actually going back all the way to 2006. Plus, as a bonus, there's the first two seasons ever of Free Talk Live there from 2002 and 2003, I think. This is way before I was part of the show, but it is still nonetheless a really cool experience to listen to and just see what Free Talk Live sounded like on its very first episode.
It's horrifying to me to think that these programs that I did, in some cases sitting in Johnson's living room.
Well, it wasn't you. It was Manwich.
Right, it was Manwich.
Just keep telling yourself that. So if you want to hear Manwich, you can go to archives.freetalklive.com. Go ahead, grab them for free. Share them with your friends. It's all available for you, archives.freetalklive.com. And the number to call tonight if you want to talk to us live is 855-450-FREE. That is, of course, the Pro XPN sponsored toll-free call-in line for you. That's 855-450-3733. You can also call us on Skype at lrn.fm. We're talking about cash-only restaurants. Are they a shady drug front 100% of the time? Or are there legit reasons why someone might want to only accept cash at their business? Isn't it kind of a voluntary transaction anyway? Isn't that the point? Is cash necessarily criminal? Is there a war on cash? Well, we'll find out answers to all those questions and more. Brian, tell us more about this article that you've got from The Gothamist about New York City cash-only businesses.
Yeah, so Gothamist, of course, feels that, yes, cash-only businesses are shady.
At least this one writer for Gothamist.
Yeah, right? Well, not just the writer, but also a business owner.
Owner who is very biased, and who only accepts credit cards.
Yeah, exactly. So he's probably been paid for by Visa or MasterCard.
Yeah, he's going completely cashless where everything's tracked.
Yeah. So I'll go on with the story. It seems to me, though, that there has been a general decline in the frequency of places like that, you know, cash only. Maybe the IRS started cracking down. Cash only is a great way to attract their attention. And it turns out the feds are quite knowledgeable about the typical proceeds of pizzerias and other all-cash businesses, and more than willing to subject the owner to one of those enhanced audits where they look at all your bank accounts, mortgage payments, the kind of car you drive, etc. After you get out of jail, you'll be lucky to have a pot to piss in or a window to throw it out of, and that's the kind of risk that entrepreneurs like to avoid. I mean, this guy is really setting up a scare here on, like, if you're thinking cash only, think again, buddy.
They will find out. Yeah. It's the all-seeing eye of Big Brother.
Yeah. So now, or maybe, and unfortunately, you know, I got to say, I don't like this whole regionalism thing, but as a New Yorker, this kind of attitude, this kind of, you know, hard edge attitude seems to be kind of common, or at least people expect it in the writing, maybe. Or maybe it's the rise of the millennials as consumers. It seems like they're the ones most likely to be paying on cards, and not accepting them is a great way to discourage a whole demographic from patronizing your establishment.
Hey, some people don't like millennials.
Yeah.
I don't know why.
Yeah. Hey, I mean, I don't know.
No, I do know why, because every older generation always thinks that the younger generation is screwing up their lives, and they're doing it wrong, and they're all bad. And
how far does this go back? I mean, you imagine,
to the beginning of time?
Can you imagine like the Viking guy, yak skin jacket, you know, like
teenagers these days
complaining about the kids, you know, railing against them?
Yeah, totally.
Or maybe you just don't want to get robbed by the kind of thieves which cash-only places attract. Seems like when you think about it, there's a lot of reasons to accept cards.
Luckily. Wow, this article is so biased.
Oh, yeah.
Is it paid for by J.P. Morgan Chase? It
makes you wonder.
Yeah.
You know, speaking of that, J.P. Morgan Chase, what is it, some odd 80 million accounts hacked.
Oh, yeah.
And boy, that means all those, and they're saying nobody
names,
has the credit
addresses,
card numbers.
Phone numbers.
Yeah,
oh, but
right.
Don't worry. Nobody, your financial information wasn't compromised.
Sure.
Just your name, address, and phone number
sure.
and email.
Exactly. No, it's not like what happened with Target or Home Depot where.
Don't you think someone could put together the pieces? Like if you've got a Chase credit card and you shop at Target. Well, now they have your name, address, phone number, and your credit card number.
Oh, they're getting a complete picture here.
Yeah.
So going on with the article, luckily the rise of Square and its competitors and soon Apple Pay and a whole class of Bitcoin-powered solutions. That's ironic. He's actually
mentioning
talking
Bitcoin.
But he's mentioning it positively, which I'm shocked at. And
doesn't know enough about it.
Sure, but I'm disturbed, actually, that he's mentioning it positively. But I'll get into more of that later. Has begun to drive down the cost and hassle of accepting credit cards. Soon, a lot of people aren't even going to be carrying wallets. And not accepting credit cards is going to mean turning away a large fraction of the public. So the cash-only establishment is probably going to become a historical phenomenon. But weep not for the passing of these places. My friend Pedro is right. They're depriving the state of tax money that goes to support all of the necessary services of our society, like the police who they'd have to call when they get robbed, or the firefighters who come when their kitchen catches on fires. F those owners. Some New York traditions are really worth leaving in the past.
Wow. That's pretty harsh.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So first of all, I'm pretty sure that if someone is actually a mafioso, like they claim, and if somebody is actually money laundering and drug dealing and their business is all just a front, they're probably not going to call the cops if they get robbed. They're probably going to take care of it themselves.
Yeah. And shouldn't they have that option? You know, shouldn't these services be voluntary?
I wish I could opt out of the police. Sometimes
absolutely.
I don't want their protection. It's more dangerous. It's bad for your health.
Well, I mean, how long do you have to wait for that protection to get to you? It's like,
when
if I'm paying out money,
count, the police are just minutes away. That's what they say.
Yeah. So, but this is really, yeah, it's scary because so many people have this attitude. But here's the scarier part for me. And that is that he knows what Bitcoin is.
And
at least a little bit.
It's good because it can be tracked.
Right. And this is a case that I've been making recently on my own show, Sovereign Tech, which you can go to sovryntech.com to hear about that. And I've been talking about it recently, and I actually talked about it in Coins in the Kingdom. We were down there for a great, great time, and I briefly mentioned it there. But, you know, I don't think I want Bitcoin to be accepted by everybody. I don't think I want it to be a part of consumer commerce, because if it means getting into the system with people like this something.
Yeah.
That's not for you.
Well, you know, what's this person, the person that was making this commentary about how everyone who does a cash business must be a bad person? What's their name? Because I want to make sure not to patronize their business.
But that's the thing is, like, Bitcoin,
I'm
one of
I'm kind of glad they outed themselves, but what other business owners actually think this but aren't saying it publicly?
Sure, but this is the thing. One of the things Bitcoin was supposed to solve was it was supposed to be kind of anonymous. It was supposed to give you control of money again. But what this guy's making a case for and using Bitcoin to help make that case is that no, you should not have that amount of control of your money. There should be protections involved. There should be, you know, all kinds of things. It should be taxed to help pay for the state. He's making the case to pay for the state and having Bitcoin be a part of that.
That is very concerning. Yeah. And just to get something clear, if you're listening to this show, you may not know what Bitcoin is. It's basically a digital currency. It's a lot more than that, but essentially that's what it is in this case that we're talking about. It's a digital currency and a peer-to-peer payment network that you can send that currency over.
And you do a show about it.
Yeah, I'm on a podcast called Let's Talk Bitcoin. It's very popular. Let'stalkbitcoin.com if you want to listen to that. But basically, a lot of people at first, when Bitcoin was just first coming out, thought it was anonymous. It's anonymous in the sense that you can send bitcoins back and forth between addresses that aren't necessarily tied to your real world name and identity. However, every Bitcoin transaction is recorded on a public ledger that's available to anyone. So if your address, Bitcoin address, is tied with your real world identity, then you've got a problem because everyone can see what you're doing. 855-450-FREE. You got questions about Bitcoin or you want to comment on cash-only businesses? 855-450-FREE.
I love my Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found my Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to mymagicmud.com and buy a jar. There's
150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin, mymagicmud.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
The warning signs.
At first, he made me feel special. He promised he'd look after me, provide for my future. He broke every promise he made.
Millions of Americans afflicted.
I was ready to leave, but he told me he'd change. So I gave him another chance. I was such a fool.
The consequences.
Things only got worse. He started making my decisions for me. About my job, my kids' education, my money. My safety, my future. He took away my choices, but I kept going back to the same politicians.
The diagnosis? Battered voter syndrome.
I fell for the same old lies. They were just playing with my emotions, telling me what I wanted to hear. That's not right.
Stop the insanity of voting for the same old abusers. Declare your independence from the two-party system and join the New Hampshire Liberty Party today. At nhliberty.info.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. This is the live Sunday night edition. Tonight it's me, Stephanie, here with you.
And Brian.
And Mark.
FreeTalkLive.com is our website where you can find, well, a bunch of stories on the front page. We have a Reddit integration on our website, which means that you can submit your favorite stories as a potential show prep for us or potential, basically, blog content for anybody who comes and visits FreeTalkLive.com. They're going to see the most popular stories up at the top of the page. And it's very easy. All you need is a Reddit account if you want to submit a story. And sometimes we consult that for show prep. So FreeTalkLive.com, you'll find that there right on the front page of our website.
Yeah, if you go to coffee.freetalklive.com, you can get a free pound of the best of the best coffee. It's shade-grown, 100% organic, and top 1% grade Arabica beans. And coffee is a very absorbent crop, so you want to, you know, that's makes that organic certification that much more important to folks. Now, BuzzBox is competitively priced with other high-end coffees, but they do something that other coffee manufacturers seem to care nothing about. They make it possible for Free Talk Live to partner with Kiva.org and give microloans to people around the world. We've already given many microloans out. We've helped lots of people to get a hand up, not a handout. They're going to pay this money back, and then we're going to give out another loan. And we're very excited about this partnership. So please, if you drink coffee, just try a free pound of coffee from coffee.freetalklive.com. And if you like it, continue to get your coffee there. They make it easy for you. They ship it right to you. You can decide on the type. You can decide on how frequently it's delivered. And you never have to think about that coffee thing again. Coffee.freetalklive.com.
You know, I think I need to come over to your house and try some of this.
It's good.
Wait, is it decaffeinated?
It is decaffeinated.
Oh, Christ.
Right. You see,
it's, Mark's is decaffeinated, but you could get a free pound of your own, right?
Many, I suppose.
At coffee.freetalklive.com.
Many coffee drinkers, you know, they disparage decaf, but, you know, for those of us who have issues around caffeine, we still like the taste of coffee. It's a godsend.
Half and man. It's water decaffeinated, right?
That's correct.
Yeah, that's probably the most natural way to do it. All right. So, Mark, what's this about purple penguins? Well, I have to hear this.
There's a school.
By the way, 855-450-FREE is the toll-free call-in line if you want to talk to us, bring up anything that's on your mind, or call about something that you heard earlier on the show. 855-450-FREE-3733.
Nationalreview.com, so this isn't biased at all. A Nebraska school district instructed its teachers to start referring to students by gendered expressions such as, referring to students by gendered expressions such as boys and girls, and use gender inclusive ones such as purple penguins instead.
Purple penguins.
Yes.
Okay. Right, so, I need to hear more about this, but hold that thought. Brian, did you have something you want to say?
Sorry. No, go ahead.
Okay. Hold that thought. We do have a call on the line. Let's bring on Nathan. Hey, Nathan, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, everyone.
And you're calling on Skype. You sound great. What's on your mind tonight?
Well, first I want to say I've been listening for about 5 minutes, and I think one of you sounds a little more effeminate than the others. Do you have, by any chance, a lady among the hosts?
You know, I'm a little bit gay, I have to say. I'm bisexual.
A little bit?
So it's a 2-for-1.
That's right.
So I thought I'd do a bit of a role reversal here, and instead of me calling about an interesting book, I want to ask Mark about an interesting book that he's recently read.
Recently read, interesting book. Okay, so the most recent book that I've read, well, I'm reading The Prince by Machiavelli, or...
Really? Il Do you Principe? Want to be feared rather than loved, Mark? Because I think we can handle that if you really want that.
I just love it when you talk like that. No, I mean,
usually I get paid for this.
You need to know what folks are saying, right? Like I think this is, it's a fascinating book. I got quite a few things out of it. I liked it a lot. What I've read recently that I liked the most was by Chaim Maccabee. It's called The Myth Maker, and it's a book about Paul. And the suggestion is that
Paul, the Apostle Paul
of Tarsus.
Okay.
Yeah, Saul of Tarsus, Paul of Tarsus. This guy is a Jewish scholar, and he essentially just kind of lays out the case that Paul is full of crap, that the most prolific writer of the New Testament is just a big fat liar. First off, he's like, Tarsus? What? Pharisee ruler is going to be from, or Pharisee, leading Pharisee is going to be from Tarsus. Paul claims to have voted for the deaths, as Saul claims to have voted for the deaths of people, that are going to get stoned. Where? The Sanhedrin? How old is Paul? And why would a Pharisee be voting in the Sanhedrin? That's what a Sadducee would do. Paul claims to be the pupil of... I can't remember the name of the sort of leading Pharisee that he talks about. He's like, this guy was the liberal that spoke up for Stephen, the martyr. So why in the world would Paul be his student and wanting to stone him? Wait a second. Paul was sent. He was sent abroad to find Christians to stone.
I am so glad we don't have much time left in the show, because this is going to turn into Bible Talk Live really quick. Yeah, if you keep talking, Mark.
I just found it fascinating that, you know, he makes the case that Jesus was a Pharisee. He makes the case that Paul was never a Pharisee, that the people out to get Jesus were the Sadducees, and that since the Gospels were written 100 years later, that people took sort of license with these titles and did whatever they did with them. Mm. I mean, it's an intellectual read. There's no doubt about it. But I was has left, I haven't seen a critique online other than, I don't like this book, right? Like, I went looking for the critiques, and this is rock solid stuff. So I recommend it. If you're pained and haunted by your religious past, I recommend this book.
Okay, Mark. As a fellow person who has spoken to divine beings in the shower, I promise I'll read this book.
Fascinating.
Excellent. Did you have anything else you wanted to ask about?
I found it online in a PDF form.
I wanted to ask about the prince, but I don't think we have much time left in the segment.
No, you can ask. Do you want to talk about the prince, Mark?
Yeah. You know, I wanted to take notes during the prince so I could really sort of talk about it. But I thought the most interesting part was how Machiavelli claims that to take over a republic, an autocrat has to live on site. And I don't think that's going to work anymore. Like, this advice is 400 years old, and maybe you could take over a republic at one point and have an autocrat live on site. But, you know, basically he says that republics are just going to, you know, they're fooled with the myth that they're free, and they're just going to continue to rebel and rebel and rebel. And I think that that's very interesting. The United States would take note.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, you're certainly not going to be constructing any fortresses in enemy territory, of course. But what I was curious about is that Machiavelli is well known for his kind of realpolitik, his idea that rulers who neglect what is for what, or that he yeah neglect what is
yeah what
for
what should be done. Be done right
for what should be done, pursue their own ruin instead of their preservation.
Sure,
and it seems to me it's a. A lot of libertarians have a similar kind of attitude. I mean, you sort of have to, right? After you've gone far enough in this. But, you know, the way Machiavelli talks, it's almost I noticed a lot of libertarians have this attitude that the people in the government aren't just incompetent, they're evil. And I wrestle with this question a lot. And
so yeah, me too.
Like, what did you get out of Machiavelli as far as that goes?
Because I haven't gotten that far. I don't consider Machiavelli evil. I consider him to be a very practical individual that understood the time frame in which he lived and said, this is how, like, you know, I'm going to be best taken care of if I'm taken care of by a ruler. And I'm going to give the rulers the best thing I can, which is advice. And the advice I have is, this is how you go about ruling. You're going to be successful if you follow these sets of rules. I don't consider him evil. I consider him self-interested.
But what experience did he have at ruling?
He worked with the French French kings essentially, and he was very much about the Italians being autonomous and whatever. I don't know. I may have that wrong. Well, I'm just reading the book, and I'm still very.
So,
early
do you
on
think
this.
The people in government are evil or incompetent or maybe a mix?
I generally think that you have to rise to the top. You have to have sociopathic tendencies. But I generally think most people working are not evil.
That's more Nathan, last word.
I said, yeah, more or less Machiavelli says, you know, keep your word when it's convenient, and otherwise break it.
Wow.
And get in power.
Thanks for the call, Nathan.
I think the book is a joke.
You think it's a joke?
I think it was written as a joke.
Evil, incompetent, or both, or maybe neither. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live, the Sunday show.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Beautiful Bellwood flooring just got even better with twice the scratch resistance and four times the abrasion resistance of other brands. And right now, Lumber Liquidators has exclusive deals on Bellwood with savings up to 40%. Choose from over 140 varieties, including Brazilian cherry, American walnut, even Bellwood's hot new matte finish that gives you that oil-finished look without all the maintenance. All with a transferable 100-year warranty. So go to LumberLiquidators.com today to find the store nearest you. First ever 36-month financing is available. But hurry, these amazing deals end Tuesday.
Question: could too many GMO foods and toxins be overloading your digestive and immune systems? Answer: yes. If you're searching for a powerful detox that's gentle enough to use every day, use Pro EM1 from Terraganics.
Pro-EM1 is a powerful liquid probiotic that uses good bacteria to suppress pathogens and gently eliminate toxins from your body. A healthy digestive system will cleanse and remove toxins, support weight loss, improve absorption of food nutrients, and aid in controlling yeast and other infections. Pro-EM1 is made with only non-GMO and certified organic ingredients, has no preservatives, and is dairy, soy, wheat, and gluten-free. Pro-EM1 is the key to your digestive health. Order Pro-EM1 Daily Probiotic Cleanse at Terraganix.com, spelled T-E-R-A-G-A-N-I-X.com. Or call toll-free 866-369-3678. That's 866-369-3678. Also available through Amazon Prime. Pro-EM1 from Terraganix. Life's getting better.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with a chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Only moments remain, one more segment in tonight's program, but you can get your calls in, if you do it quick, at 855-450-3733. That's 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. Those are the Pro XPN toll-free call-in lines. And with you tonight, it's me, Stephanie.
And Brian.
And Mark.
All right, let's go right to the phones and talk with Joseph, listening in South Carolina. Hey, Joseph, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes.
Hey, my name is Joe. I'm calling from South Carolina.
Welcome.
And I'm pretty new to the show. In fact, I actually heard about y'all from a friend of mine. And one of the reasons I was calling is to find out a little bit more about what y'all do as far as y'all's beliefs. And then give you some of my own opinions when it comes to governmental corruption.
All right. Well, do you have any specific questions, or do you want to just hear the elevator pitch?
Sure. The elevator pitch will work great.
Sure. Free Talk Live is a nationally syndicated radio program on more than 160 stations across the country. We take calls from anybody about anything, but we take a stand on the issues that's pro-freedom. We believe that free people working in concert with each other, in competition and cooperation, can always find solutions and innovations that are better than what governments can do. Governments are monopolies. Monopolies traditionally provide bad service, bad customer service, higher prices, and create a dangerous atmosphere for innovation. So we're against it.
All right. Sounds great. So what is y'all's take on common law versus statutory law?
Well, most statutory laws come out of common law.
Real quick, it's important to point out that like there's a lot of hosts on Free Talk Live, so everybody has different opinions.
Yeah, that's it's true a seven yeah. night a week show.
I was just trying to give you the elevator pitch. Yeah. I don't think that I'm too far off for most folks.
Go for it.
Mark, you're on the show 6 nights a week.
That's true.
So, go ahead, so Mark. Common law versus statutory law?
I think the common law is, you know, was the basis of the laws that we currently have. I'm a little skeptical with some of the rhetoric that flies around about common law. I'm much more interested in natural law.
Okay, so, for instance, in the Constitution, are y'all familiar with Black's Law Dictionary?
Yes.
I've heard of it.
Okay, so Black's Law Dictionary, 5th edition mainly, is what most lawyers and magistrates go by. In Black's Law Dictionary, corporation, individual, person, et cetera, are all considered the same thing, which is a corporate entity. So if you go outside of common law and you're under admiralty law, maritime law, statutory law, and you're under the jurisdiction of courts and magistrate, then that's who you are in the Constitution, meaning we are the people of, you know, the United States Constitution, the preamble.
Right. This is kind of like a sovereign citizen kind of.
I go over the government. I created the government. The government creates or goes over the citizens. So in the statutory law.
You know, Joe, you might be really interested to talk to Ian. He's on the other 6 nights of the week, so Monday through Saturday. He's actually tried testing some of these theories in court. He's had numerous court cases where he's tried various elements of, testing the all caps theory.
He's declined the services of, the courts and got thrown in jail for 90 days for, whatever that disrespect.
The couch on the front yard?
Disrespecting the judge.
Contempt of
contempt,
court.
That's right.
Yeah, so.
Well, you would have to go to an appellate court because appellate court judges or over circuit court judges, they don't understand common law on a circuit level.
You can't take contempt to an appellate court. Contempt is a power of the court.
No, not under statutory law. But we're talking.
Well,
we're talking
he ended up in jail
law.
Anyway. I mean,
you can't take anything anywhere in jail.
Yeah.
Hey, I would love to have a conversation with Ian about this, and I think you should call in
on any night of the week that's not Sunday, if that's possible for you. And thank you so much, Joe. I appreciate your call tonight. I don't know much about that whole thing. I just try to avoid the cops as much as I can.
I've seen people be successful in videos with that stuff, and I've seen them be unsuccessful. So,
sometimes they're very short on videos. Like, sometimes there just aren't many videos.
Yeah, there aren't many.
Yeah, that people claim that they've used this stuff in court, but they don't have video. So, what are you supposed to do? All right, let's talk to Troll. Hey, Troll, you're on Free Talk Live. That is the name that they gave the call screener.
How's life under the bridge?
Troll, you're on the air.
Hi, y'all.
Yeah?
Hey, I was wondering about, speaking of sociopaths rising to the top, and a couple of them I can think off the top of my head, Hitler and Mao, they both had something in common with another sociopath. Ian, they have teenage girlfriends. How come there's no adult in that house that will do something about that?
Talk to you later, Troll.
Well, while we're at it, I mean, yeah, Hitler had something in common with sociopaths, Christianity. Oh, whoops. Oh, that might have.
Yeah.
Well, Mao and.
Mao didn't.
Yeah. Mao and Stalin. I don't think you can link Christianity
to
sociopathy.
No, I wouldn't dream of it, nor would I try to link.
Apparently you would.
In the first place, when somebody tries to link something else to Ian Freeman, that, I mean, to compare him to Hitler is insanity.
It's a pretty strained analogy.
Yeah, or to Mao. I mean, that's like assuming that Ian has somehow been voted into some kind of office, or that anyone like even wants to take him more seriously than they desire to by the force of the gun. Ian has none of those traits. Why would you compare it to those kind of people? Clearly, it's just a troll.
Well, self-described.
And a pathetic one at that.
All right. So tell me more about this purple penguin thing.
Yeah, the school board here from a Nebraska school district is advising teachers not to use gender inclusive language such as purple penguins. Don't use phrases such as boys and girls, you guys, ladies and gentlemen, and similarly gendered expressions to get kids' attention, instructs a training document given to middle school teachers at the Lincoln Public Schools. Create classroom names and then ask all the purple penguins to meet on the rug, as it advises. This is middle school? You get knifed over this stuff.
Wow. I mean, yeah, I thought, that does seem a little bit strange.
With kindergartners or first graders, I can see this purple penguin thing flying. But beyond that, I mean, you're talking about sixth graders, seventh graders, eighth graders?
So why would they call them purple penguins instead of just kids or y'all or hey you or...
All right, children.
Yeah.
Young adults.
Young adults, yeah.
I don't see anything wrong with people. ladies and gentlemen anyway. I mean, if you are gender dysphoria or whatever, usually you self-identify as one of those two things anyway, right? I mean, there are people that call themselves androgynous, right? I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, there's a whole spectrum. Like, now I think people are, you know, there definitely are some people who are really comfortable with male or female. Like, I feel like I am a man, or I feel like I am a woman. But that's not everybody. Some people just don't fall neatly into one of those two categories. And there's been a lot more attention, I guess, paid to those people recently, because they're finally beginning to be acknowledged that they actually exist. And, you know, maybe we shouldn't have these bathrooms that are men's and women's, because some people want to change their gender. Some people don't strongly identify with a gender. You know, maybe we should just have single stall bathrooms that anyone can use.
Yeah, I think it's probably what it's going to come to, is these single stall bathrooms. But it gets more costly. A single stall bathroom has to have a sink that's separate and all those things. And I don't know. I mean, I don't feel like people can go in and out as quickly, that you can cycle through them. They're less efficient and that sort of thing. I don't know.
Well, yeah, I don't know. I mean, if you're thinking about a gas station, is it more costly to have two just single stall bathrooms, or is it more costly to have two, like, bathrooms, one men and one women's, with multiple stalls in each one?
I find it, when you do have single stall bathrooms, that why do we have men's and women's written on these doors? Is it because, you know, the men should have to
cross-contaminate?
The men should have to deal with the men's messes and the women should have to deal with the women's messes? Is that the idea here? And I've heard that women's bathrooms are messier, but I wouldn't know. I don't clean them. I mean, I can't. Right. I cannot say.
Can we just get over nudity? Like, get over the fact that some people have large breasts.
Who's nude in the bathroom?
Well, that's the thing. It's like, okay, why is there even a difference?
Yeah.
Right? But, like, why is there a difference between a men's room and a women's room, even if it was, like, multi-stall or whatever?
You know,
if the women are dirtier, I want them in their own room.
I had to tell this story. So, when I was in college, I actually got a citation for sexual harassment.
Okay.
Because it's not nearly as exciting as it sounds.
I've given her plenty of these citations. So
pull over.
So, I lived in a...
The punishment must fit the crime.
I lived in a building where there was only one bathroom on each floor. And the men's bathroom was on one floor and the women's bathroom was on the other floor. And, you know, you had to walk up and down the stairs in the middle of the night. I didn't feel comfortable doing that. So once I went in the men's bathroom and I got written up. Imagine that. Bad girl. This has been Free Talk Live. Visit us at freetalklive.com. It's been me, Stephanie.
And Brian.
And Mark.
See you next week.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at shiresociety.com. That's shiresociety.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Ovaltine. Give your kids the nutrition they need to be their best. Visit us at OvaltineUSA.com. Telling your child about healthy food choices is important, but showing her what to eat goes a lot further. Have her help create the grocery list, then bring her to the store with you. Picking out healthy foods together helps kids get in the habit of thinking about what they're eating every day. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, October 10th, 2014. Gold is trading around $1,229, silver around $17.56, and Bitcoin around $370. Today's precious metal prices are brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. Support for Liberty Beat comes from SovereignMiners.com. Interested in mining Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies? Well, Sovereign Miners has you covered. All purchases come with a free script ASIC miner. Visit SovereignMiners.com to buy your miner today. In the news, on Wednesday, arguments concluded in a hearing on force feeding at the Guantanamo Bay military prison. Lawyers with Human Rights Group Reprieve represented Syrian detainee Abu Wail Diab in a hearing that will determine the legality of the force feeding and whether or not 32 videos of the procedure will be released to the public. Diab's team presented three expert witnesses, while the government failed to present any. Judge Gladys Kessler is expected to rule on the matter in the coming weeks. Thousands of demonstrators marched through Mexico's capital this week, calling on the government to investigate missing students and a recently discovered mass grave. 43 students went missing after a clash with police in Iguala in the state of Guerrero on September 26. A mass grave filled with burned human bodies was also found over the weekend. Guerrero's attorney general said it was probable that some of the 28 bodies found belonged to the missing students. On Monday, New York Supreme Court Justice Paul Wooten ruled that the high-rise safety initiative will not appear on the November 4th ballot. The initiative was an effort to investigate all high-rise collapses on or since September 11, 2001, including World Trade Center 7. Justice Wooten sided with a court-appointed referee's recommendations that the petition to be on the ballot be denied. However, the justice called the city's efforts to dismiss the case based on technicalities.